What's up, everybody? This is John Q.
And this is Alex A.
And you are listening to Free Music Reviews with Consult Q&A.
You can catch us live on twitch.tv/allmyhomies or youtube.com/allmyhomies every Wednesday night at 8:30.
And you can visit our website, www.consultqa.com, to submit every Wednesday. Follow us on all social media at Consult Q&A.
Boom. Be good. Hi, everybody. How's it going? Oh, hey. Do we pause the music? Do we want the music paused?
No, I just turned it down.
Oh.
No, it is not.
Oh, wow. They think you're Kim. I don't know if I can hear myself in my head. Oh, there we go. Why am I so bassy?
Thanks.
Yeah.
Can you
proximity
hear me?
Effects.
Yeah. No, why am I? What is
why
going
do I feel
on?
Like I can't hear myself?
Oh, you can turn yourself up in the headphones there.
My headphones?
Yeah, I just turned you up in your headphones.
Yeah, I can hear better now.
Oh, that's why. Because what? My EQ
hey,
was
Mateo.
Set to normal. My EQ is set.
Somebody wants a Jack and Coke.
Yeah.
We don't have a bartender.
Yeah, there's no.
Somebody call the bartender.
Yeah, the bartender's supposed to be behind the bar the whole time.
The whole time. Yeah, where's the amp?
Yeah, Mr. Rogers' neighborhood stuff. How's our audio, everybody? What's going on?
What's up, Deidre?
Yeah, what's happening? How's everything sounding to the people on YouTube? A lot of people. Oh, shouts out to Jason in the building.
I'm shiny. I've had a long day.
They're gonna get on you about the shininess.
Better autofocus.
They just straight get on me about the shiny all stream, but they're gonna get on you. All right, we're gonna turn you up a little bit.
You can
more
only
too.
Hear Kim. I'm actually Jen, not Kim. Kim is sitting over there.
Isn't it crazy? Like, y'all don't look anything alike.
We don't look anything alike. I think it's because of the glasses and the braids.
Oh, they're saying they can only hear Kim over there, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, so they can't hear us. Oh. So maybe it's picking up her computer's laptop.
All of you, everybody sounds good.
What? Wait.
What?
Yeah, what? Like every stream. Oh, okay.
You know, right. I just was going back on our streams and I got onto the stream. I finally watched the view from their perspective of just us going like, yeah, this music's great. And then
your
Kim just
out?
Going.
Oh. He's wearing leggings.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't understand this chat. I am wearing leggings though.
His knees are not out today.
Yeah, I am wearing leggings, but they will talk about the shininess.
Okay.
So be prepared for that. But maybe they won't do it because they may fear getting canceled.
Wow. Wow. This is how we're starting this?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Oh my God.
I guess we can start it a little better with introductions.
Yeah.
So, let me play a little musical background music. Like, hey everybody.
Oh God.
Welcome to Consult Q&A.
Yeah.
We have Alex in the building.
Yeah.
I go by the name of John Q.
Yeah.
Hold up. It was supposed to be instrumental. I go by the name of John Q. We have a special guest with us today. It's the illustrious, lovely, beautiful, chocolate skinny, having mocha shining on camera. Everywhere she goes.
Everywhere.
Jennifer, don't forget the H. Desire. She's in the building.
Yay.
Thank you. Oh, those are the
applause. Yeah, that was the applause, but we doing finger snaps.
All right, that's what we're doing. Okay. Hey, guys, I'm Jen. I'm not Kim. I'm Jen.
And now you know.
It's with a J.
Yeah.
It's Jennifer. H. Don't forget the H.
Beautiful chocolate skinny. Or shiny.
I think I said shiny. Oh, skin. I said skin, but I put Y, skinny. So I said skinny.
Skin.
For skin. Skinny. So it's skin. It's SKINIE. Not with the Y.
Thank you. Thank you. I'll take it all.
Put an apostrophe after the IE.
Stop. No more.
For the English language.
There it is.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay. All
for
right.
The English
thank
there
you.
It is. There it is. Yeah, so skinny will be a new term about glorious skin.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, made
like
it up.
Right, I like now. It. Patent that.
It is. Say it first on this stream.
You it's heard copy. It here first, folks.
It's copywritten. I don't follow DJ Rode. Come on, DJ Rode, you're getting followed. All right, so I'm gonna have this music.
Why don't we have Jen tell everyone about her?
Yeah, Jen. That was my bad. Jen, if you would like
or
to tell everybody about
certain
yourself.
Events coming up, or I don't know. We could talk a lot. We could talk a little. Gonna do some music reviews. Talk in your mic.
Oh God. All right. So my name is Jennifer and I run a company called Fusion & Co. in Orlando. We are a independent artist platform and we create shows, workshops. We also have I would say agency that help artists become brands and businesses. And we work with a lot of local artists in Orlando and we've been around for 6 years now. Yeah, that's what I do.
Cool.
Yeah.
Very cool.
She does a lot more than that.
Yeah.
She's just over here flagging.
I just wanted to make it like short and sweet. Mm-hmm. You know, that's mm-hmm. like the basic. You all know?
Right. Jen been in this game for about 15 years. She hopped off the block when she was young. She's been in this game for about 15 years. She started out the mud.
Yeah.
She was mm-hmm. in the mud and the trenches.
Facts.
So she's been in the music industry for a while. She has some accolades underneath her
Thank
belt.
Thank you.
You yeah. know, so
I've done my work.
Yeah,
I think
you've worked with artists and major labels, so your opinion is valuable. And
yeah,
valuable.
I worked at Interscope for a little while.
Oh, that's
and,
cool.
It's been an interesting life in the music world. Just kind of like being in Orlando and just doing my little thing. I call it little because I still think I'm still barely touching the surface. And working at a label where, you know, they have the resources and they yeah. have the money and they have the reach that I don't have. So it's a little different, but I'm here in Orlando now. And yeah, I like it. I All like right. it here.
Yeah, get used to people looking at you through the window. It's about to get weird. Yeah. So we were supposed to have a QR code in the window so people can scan it. But
That'd
Alex,
be nice.
But I forgot to bring it. Yeah. I printed it. It's there at my house. What's up, Gabe?
Yeah, so outside of that, you've worked with some fun artists doing both. Like, so at Interscope, what exactly did you do? Tell us a little bit about the behind the scenes part that people may not know about that goes on behind the scenes.
Okay, so basically my job was pretty much to come up with campaigns. So basically, let's say you're an artist and you work at a label. The label have a certain amount of budget that they're going to use to push your project before you release it. So I would be able to, I guess, sit into your sessions, listen to the music that you're creating. And from that time, I have to somehow come up with a marketing campaign that is going to get everyone to love every single song that you're going to release in 6 months.
Okay. Where was the artist in this decision making?
The artists obviously have the last word in whether or not they want that to be what we do. But eventually, the biggest part is when you create a campaign, everyone that's in the label have to approve of it. Everyone have to get behind it. It can't just be like, oh, I think I'm going to have you perform in front of this building every day for 60 days. And, you know, that's the idea and that's it. Like every single person because when you are marketing a part of the marketing crew, you're not just by yourself. There's different people doing different things. So your idea has to come to life by working with a team. So every single person that's within that team has to agree to it. And then you can present to the artist, because a lot of time what happened is, you know, we come up with an idea, and that happened to me a lot. You come up with an idea and you think is the best idea that you've come up with. And, you know, you present it. The artist is like, nah, we're not doing that. We ain't doing this. Hell no. And, you know, it breaks you because you think it's the best idea. And to somebody that doesn't really know themselves and what they're trying to put out to the world, they'll be like, okay, let's do it. Or somebody that doesn't pay attention.
Yeah.
They'll just be like, okay, let's do it. But with marketing and what we do, this is really what makes or breaks the selling of that project. you know, when artists put out campaigns, some people promote a song for a year. Mm-hmm. So if they want to promote that song for an entire year, you have to come up with all types of ideas mm-hmm. for them to be able to push that song or that project for a whole year. And that's done like 6 to a year in advance. Yeah. It's not done after the songs are done. It's not done after you release the songs. It's done before you even have, you know, you record 80 songs for your project until you get your down to your 12 song. You know, that's when it's like done. That stuff is done way ahead.
Yeah.
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 And with all that being said, that's who we have here with us today. So,
why would somebody want to push one song for a whole year? I think it just depends on your goals for it. I think sometimes, you know, some songs are throwaway songs. Some songs you just have to put them out because you're trying to get out of your deal. But then some songs you really want it to impact people. You really want it to be like that one number one song. And if you're not an artist with a reach like Summer Walker or like Beyonce or like Drake, it may take you a year to get that number one song. It may take you a year to get the impact that you're going to have with that song. I think it all ultimately it depends on what your goals are for that song. You don't have to push a song for a whole year, but if that's what you want to do, you can.
You just got to be prepared for it.
Yeah. the biggest example is Fetty Wap pushed, what's it called, for 2 years. Mm-hmm. Hello, whatever it was. I don't remember, but that was 2 years of him doing that. And there's a bunch of, yeah, somebody just said it in the chat. Yeah. Fetty Wap, Trap Queen for 2 years.
Yeah.
There's a lot of examples of that. If you think back to the early 2000s, people were pushing songs for like a year and a half. They would push it in their city for about 2 years.
Yeah.
And then it finally would make it outside exactly. of the city. Mm-hmm. That's why
then
a lot
you gotta push it again.
Yeah.
With some money.
And that's why a lot of people would be like, yo, this song is like 6 years old. And then it's like, oh, but it just released. Uh-huh. And it's like, well, it just released on the label. But it's been on mixtape. So back in the mixtape era, the mixtape would come out like 6 months. 7 months, 8 months, a year, and then this person would be pushing his song. I mean, who a designer? What didn't designer do yeah. a mixtape song and then Kanye West put it out or something like that? I don't know how design Ant probably knows. He was the one telling me these stories. But yeah, and with that, one thing I wanted to ask is so does the artist usually give y'all feedback on what they may how they may want to be marketed, or is yeah. it just like, hey, present me stuff and I'll pick?
Not yeah, the artists definitely do have a lot of creative control on what they want to do, especially with the label that I work with. We work with artists like Summer Walker and Black and Boogie and Drum. Now he's back to being Drum.
I'm glad. I didn't know Drake security guard beat him up over, because remember
yeah I was
with that
yeah
so on the stream huh. Remember when I was talking about how Drake stole his song,
right?
So Drum,
I saw that story.
Yeah, Drum actually confronted him about it and he got beat up by Drake security guard. And Drake, because the song used to originally be called I Like to Cha-Cha Remix. Mm-hmm. I still have it in my computer as that. And when Drake released it, that's what it was called. And then he changed the name. But Drum confronted him about it because he got no credit. And then Drake security guard beat him up.
Yeah, I heard that story. And then it's also been another story, because recently in Drake's new songs, he said something about it. And Drum had something else to say about it on Instagram. It was like a whole deal.
Yeah. Back and forth.
Yeah. Yeah, so the artists definitely... So with the label that I work with, we work with artists that are very... I would say I have a huge following, and a lot of people have a lot of, I think a lot of people judge Summer Walker more than they judge any other artist, female artist than I can think of, honestly. And I think with Summer, she's very conscious of who she is. She's very aware of her reach and what she can get done. And she likes to make sure everything kind of like is her. Like, she doesn't want it to be anything other than her, and it can't make her feel uncomfortable when she's a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Because she already has that issue with like being up around people, so everything has to kind of like reflect on her personality in a way. And we have to also think about, how would this make her feel if she had to do this by herself? And she's always the one that's like, no. I will say that she's always like, no, like, we're not doing that, because that means I have to do all of this, and I don't want to do all of this. But definitely, like, I know Black, with Black, he's very like hands-on with everything he does. Like, he thinks about everything that he wants to do for his entire project. So it's just a matter of working with the artists and trying to bring their ideas to life, but then also having ideas that you can add on to be like, oh, you thought about this, how come, why can't we pair this with that? And then they will go into this and then they'll be like, oh, that's fire, let's do that. Mm-hmm. Rather than like, this is what I want you to do and that's it.
Yeah,
like we don't do that at that label. So I think that was different because I feel like a lot of artists don't get to have that creative control ever. So to be able to be at a label that actually values that is phenomenal.
Cool.
Very cool.
All right. So yes, with that being said, again, that's who we have here with us. She does have a show, a award show coming up.
Oh God.
And that's on the 30th and that's in Orlando. We'll discuss, we'll talk about
later
that. Yeah. A little bit later, but she is going to be reviewing things. So You've had your fair share of reviewing music in your past, haven't you?
Yeah. I try not to do it anymore. I do it like on my own time and just like chill.
Yeah, people still saying, hey, can you listen to my So you are going to be honest here, right? You have the experience of being critically
I'm gonna
honest.
Be honest and I'm gonna actually say what I feel is wrong and what you could add.
There we go.
Rather than be like, this sucks.
There we go.
All right.
and with that being said, we do have a good amount of submissions today. Nothing too crazy.
I have a song. Can you play mine?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah, we'll play your song.
Play my song.
Thought you was a rapper now. So somebody.
I need a rapper name.
So, all right. So I always ask the chat because there's some people who submitted way earlier. So I think this was on the 9th. Was it the 9th last Wednesday? Never mind. No. We're incomplete in that. We'll do that there. So if we start off today, Dollar Water would be the first, and Dollar Water can choose to skip and go second and have Space Jet go first.
Dollar Water's first.
But you know, something
this prepared.
This is like he submitted at 12:53 a.m.
He was totally ready for this. Good for him.
Yeah, what's the chat talking about? I don't know what the chat's talking. If you're trying to get signed to a label and get a physical release funded, should you put your music out first on streaming and such, or try to get it to come out on the label itself at the same time? That's an interesting question, and it's a hard to answer question from my experience. So it'll be interesting if Jen has had experience with that as well, or Alex has had experience.
Funded, would you put your music out first or try?
So
you trying to get it funded?
Yeah,
like I think
that's what I was about to ask about that.
Because labels don't just fund a song.
If they fund it, they probably have the master. So it has to come out on the label first. But if a label's not going to just give you money and be like, hey, have fun.
Yeah, this day and age, especially with like TikTok or something, you got the song made, it's out there. And then the label's like, oh, hey, people are dancing to this on TikTok. So we'll take that from you if you want.
Yeah, we'll do a master buyout or we'll do something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Or it's pretty much a master buyout, or they'll try to sign you on some kind of deal or something like that. But they're not going to just be like, here's $10,000 of development money.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Maybe after
let us
that
know.
First phase, maybe for your second or third album, maybe.
Now, if you're a producer and you produce a track for an artist that is on a label and that artist is signed and that artist plans on releasing it, you as the producer cannot, even if you can't release it on your own. It's usually in the contract that you cannot do that. So it has to be the artist. If the artist is going to release it, that's in his contract with the label, or the label will release it.
I mean, if I was an artist and I needed to get some type of label backing, what I would do is I would sign a artist development contract with the label and have them help me with finding the better ways to market and put out my song, rather than like them owning anything that I have. Because once you sign with a label, like you have to pick and choose what you have, what you're gonna give them. And realistically, a lot of artists don't have any leverage to give for any labels nowadays. They just, I don't know, I think it's really hard for you to think that a label is just gonna give you money for nothing. Like
it's kind of an old school mentality. Like it's kind of that, like, and he even asked a follow up, like, are buyouts more common? Like even submitting a demo to a label,
they don't care.
Yeah. Like I don't know. There's a million different stories about how people got signed to labels. Some of them like just threw a demo at a guy and that guy was like, oh, hey, I love this. But more commonly, they're just hang all the A&Rs just hang out on TikTok.
Yeah. That's what I was going to say. Yeah, the easiest way for anybody to get signed right now in this day and age is TikTok and Instagram. You can slide in somebody's DM on Instagram and set up a label meeting.
Yeah. AMH says this every label talk, have leverage. Leverage. End of the story.
There it is.
But it's true. I can go to a label and be like, hey, I can show you my numbers and everything that I've done and every ticket I've sold at Fusion, and then you can pay me so I can help you push your artists in Orlando because I have every single number of every show that I've sold out.
Right.
I have that leverage and they'll pay me to do it.
Yeah.
But if you have nothing, that's why I tell artists, sell your tickets. Keep count. Have how many tickets you sold this year.
I don't need to sell tickets. My name sells tickets.
You know what I'm saying? They'll ask you because the first thing you do when you get on a label, I guarantee you, because there's a kid right now that is working with LVRN. And before I left, that's what I was working on. He was trying to get on shows. Literally, the label is reaching out to everybody they know to put this kid on shows, like little shows, like open mics. Showcases because he doesn't have anything.
Gotta build it.
You gotta build it.
Yep. So that's why I'm like, you do a lot of this stuff on your own. And when you have the leverage, you can actually sell yourself. If you want to, you can sell yourself to a label. If you want to. There's many things you can do, but you know what I'm saying. There's a lot. But see, this is the first time the chat doesn't care if we review music.
Literally. They're not banging down the door.
Yeah. Literally. Right, I'm going to stop talking.
No, usually they're like, John, shut up. Alex, shut
up.
You're
doing that thing where you go, flap, 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 not playing my music.
Play my song.
Let's hear some songs.
But I guess it's because she's has an illustrious voice. Her skin is glowing.
Shiny. That's what they said. It was shiny.
What's the word? Skinny.
Like Dollar Water doesn't even care. He's like, I'm the first one, but I don't care if we even go. We having this type of talk. You know, so we do music reviews. I mean, we do two every 45 minutes.
I vote one.
But so let's jump into this. Bro, y'all will forever be my favorite. Well, thank you for that. Oh, wow. Amp says, shut up. Let Jen keep dropping gems.
Wow.
Because we don't do it. We don't
think
drop
gems. It's different
gems.
When someone else is here. I think they're used to you. It's like you guys are like their brothers.
They don't listen to anything.
Exactly. It's like your brother telling you to go wash the dishes, but then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're not going to do it.
Definitely don't listen to anything we say.
Shut up. First. Let Jen keep dropping gems.
Who's first would be Dollar Water. Dollar sent. So they sometimes, he sent over a love letter. Sent over a track called Real Lies. He said, same beat as a previous submission, but it no longer is about polar bears. Okay.
Oh.
Producer wanted me to write a verse about how fucked up the world is. It's been a pleasure, y'all. I'm off for boot camp. Are you going to the military? So it'll be many months before y'all hear from me again. I've been hoarding content to keep my social active while I'm gone. Salute. God bless. Happy holidays. Stay hydrated. Dollar Ward, I thought you were older than me. I thought the cutoff... You are not going to no boot camp.
He's pulling a Hogan Moore with his kid. Hogan Moore doesn't have a kid.
Yeah. I don't think he has a kid.
A tech boot camp.
Okay. Never heard of that. Good for you.
That's a good thing to do.
What's a tech boot camp?
Learning how to code.
For months? You can't, do anything
else?
They
make you do a shitload of push-ups. I don't know. I've never been to a tech boot camp.
Is it like truck driving school where it's like you go to truck driving school for 6 months and nobody hears from you?
Yeah, you got to learn how to back up the computer.
Where is that at? In Atlanta or something?
Double entendre.
Truck driving school?
No, the tech boot camp.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, what?
Because Atlanta is going crazy with tech right now.
Yeah. I think UCF's trying to do stuff too. He's focused. Good for you.
Okay. Shouts out to that man, Dollar Water, taking care of his family. Let's check this track out. It's called Real Lies. Let me find it right here. No, that's Red Code.
That?
I don't know. Oh, that's my boy outside. What's up, man? All right. Real Lies. It's a Real Lies reference track. Let's check this out.
Thank you for the follow.
Ain't no resting of living a life so reckless, knowing that time is borrowed. Studio sessions, rolling up some of that effort. I could die like tomorrow. Started out bony in the birds of Bokeh. Now I'm in Colorado, yeah. High revolver. Bumping that Cam Invada, I look nonchalant in the face. Inside, I be going through things. Man, I've been drowning so long. These days, I don't mind a little rain. Lately, I be laying low. I don't even cut the fader wrong. Most side, never close by. What's the use even praying, bro? Losing it little by little. Look at the world that we live in. I'm keeping my head on a swivel. Wouldn't matter if I did it. I feel like I'm stuck in the middle. Pro-life, pro-choice. Trump this, Trump that. Noise, 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 noise. Workaholics worry about nothing but direct deposits. Knuckleheads living life light. Living ain't an option. Young queens in the making. Trading privacy for payment. Hard living in a generation. Faceless. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Man, I had like so many different emotions.
Okay.
Cool.
We just gonna let this ride. But we can
guitar solo outro.
All right. I mean, I can go real quick or you guys can take it away. Okay. So I really like that better than the polar bear song.
He got it. That's literally what I thought.
Last part sounded like yes. Section 80. Okay.
That's literally what I thought.
The whole section 80.
The whole of the
yeah, all of section 80.
Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah, okay.
That song, that's literally what, like, the all's my life I like to the part. Yeah. Like that sounded like that in that end.
Word.
Anyways,
I like this better than the polar bear part. I'm not going to talk about the mix. What I'm going to talk about is I feel some places in the beat the snare could have rolled into octaves. Just to add a little spice into it. So, like, he didn't really have a snare roll or anything, but I think a snare roll added in some places that maybe rolled octaves. Eclipse does it a lot. You could also do a hi-hat roll in the, like, go up an octave with it, like, but going up an octave while it's rolling.
Yeah.
I think that would have added a little bit of extra spice to it. And I feel it's like that's all the beat really needed was just a tiny, tiny bit of extra spice.
Mm-hmm.
And then it would sound complete because right now it almost feels undone.
I'm gonna jump in.
Okay.
Psycho Motion's here.
You're not gonna kiss him out.
One thing that I did notice, I mean, mix aside, it does need a mix, but I do like that repeating thing that was kind of like panning back and forth.
That was cool.
I did like that, but it did make me notice like how mid-range scoop the entire song is. Like the vocals sit kind of in the high mids, the beat sits in the very lows, and there's this great big space, and it felt empty for me until that part came in, and then I was just like, oh, it's mid-range that I need. So I would say if it does come to a mix, like fill in that space with like Let your lows extend a little bit into the mids. Let your vocals extend a little bit into the mids. And that way it won't make it. To me, it was kind of jarring, but I really liked that mid-range thing going on.
You know what's really interesting?
What?
Hearing music being reviewed from different perspectives. I feel like you guys are
we're
talking.
Yin and yang.
Yeah, but it's more in a, like a sound engineer type thing. And then like my perspective would be different.
Yeah,
more
yeah.
like an A&R perspective.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's good.
Is, yeah, that's
why you're here.
Oh, gosh. All right, so my thoughts were in the beginning, like right when you started the song, I thought I was listening to a Lauryn Hill sample. I don't know. That's just my thought.
I think he said that was his 4-year-old.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what I thought. And then at first, I couldn't understand fully what you were saying, but then, like, in the second part, I could completely understand what you were saying, and I wasn't lost. I think sometimes what happened, people would just kind of, like, do these bars that nobody seemed to catch or, like, understand. And the first couple seconds, I didn't understand, but then it made sense later on, and it came together. And at the end, I thought about, like, the Kendrick Lamar song that I was just saying. I'm not saying you sound like Kendrick. I'm not saying that the song, it just, that was just like my first thought process when I heard it, just kind of like how the sound comes together. Overall, I like the song. I don't know any of the sound stuff they talked about. Like, I get it, but like,
let's go.
My brain doesn't work like that. I think that I would love to see, like, I'm a live music girl. Like, I like seeing songs live. So I think like seeing it put together would be cool. But yeah, I like it. Definitely, if you're going to like, I always tell rappers, like, if people can understand what you're saying, then more likely they're going to be able to repeat what you're saying. So make sure when you talk about something, people are able to understand what you're saying so they can catch on.
There you go.
That's it.
There you go.
All right. So shouts out to Dollar Water for that track. It's called Realize. It says it's a reference track. So if it's not finished, I would like for you to send it to me when it is finished. Because that's something I would play if I'm doing like a little hippity hippity hops mix. Mm-hmm. I would throw that in the mix. Yeah. So I would like for that to be sent to me. If the chat room hasn't said anything, they got like really quiet,
really absorbed into the review that we've got going on.
Is the chat room listening today?
I feel like it's gonna click all at once. We're gonna get 50 messages.
Words. Space just says, speaking of such, I finally put lyrics on my in the comments. If you care to follow along, okay. Dollarwood said it's crazy y'all said that because it was Kendrick on by the World that I was going for. Okay,
oh, cool.
Gabe says low-key multitasking right now. Okay, shouts out to you, Gabe. Space just said, I mean, I heard it. I fuck with Dollar. All right, bet. Cool. Okay, he all heard right. it. Yeah. Word. All right, that's we'll take it. We'll go like that. Up next, we got Mustafa's in the building. Shouts out to him. Up next, we got Space J. I know Viuda's here, so you know. Oh, everybody is here, I think.
Yeah.
All right, but up next,
list today.
We got Space Jit. Space Jit sent over a track that I do not know how to say, but I'm going to let Jim sound this out because y'all be... All right, Jen.
It's me.
Yeah. Wait, hold on. How do you say that?
Why should I know?
No, just...
Like, why would I know? I feel like you're being racist
now. No. Like, every stream.
Trick.
Every stream, I can't read it. Now, how do you feel... Actually, let me wait. I'll wait till after you hear his music before I ask this question.
It'll make sense.
Okay. All right.
All right.
So let's check this out. Space Jit's song.
My semen, she loving. Oh, I should make it disappear. I'm on TC, ain't drinking beer. No, I don't got no friends, so you gotta be full. And I ain't talking about I'm doing the most. Really thinking I'm in love with it. It ain't shit to say, I feel my life fall. And even if I tell the truth, they won't know. This is why I might prefer to be alone. Yeah, I made you mine. No, I still can't feel you. Love of my life now. Ain't got no issue. Yeah, if you got problems, you start them. Yeah, I just be chillin' and niggas start trippin' by night. Yeah, we broke up. How the fuck we back together? At this point, I don't even think that shit matters. Is it love or something different? I'll say the love. We met for each other. Yeah, I made your mind. No, I still can't feel you. Love of my life.
Oops, my bad. I guess we'll just be pretty faces. Until then. Yeah, that looked like a refresh right there. I think y'all are back. There it is. Okay. Word. Okay, great. All right, so since we cut out, I'm going to still play a little bit more of Space Jit so y'all can get the ending of that.
You know, watch me get violent. So my heat becomes on the line. And that magician, my semen, she loving. Fast, keep it real. Yeah.
Yeah. I hate you. Now
you done said that you was gonna pull up. Man, this time we're doing for real. It's feeling like I'm Kishi the Oma. Yeah, I'ma sell it like LaFell. Collect the crop and do what I wanna. Keep me 9-11 and shit.
All right, so Jen, with hearing that, I want to ask you, do you think the writing helps his brand? Because how would you look up this song?
I don't know what's happening. Like, no, like, for real. Like, I'm really honest. Like, I really don't know what's happening. I don't understand, you know, the writing of it. I don't know if anyone would be able to find that if they were looking for it. That's if they're looking for it. I don't know who's looking for that. And that song sounds like somebody's on really bad drugs and they need to, like, I don't know. Like, I seen the video and it's very trippy and it makes me feel lightheaded. The song makes me feel lightheaded. Why is that a bad thing?
Like no. I feel it's like your opinion.
I feel like that's on brand for him. No, I feel like he's. I feel like that's what he's going for.
See, that's the.
No, say it.
Yeah.
All right, so I think. I used to work at this studio in 2014 called Level 11.
Yeah, I remember.
You know that studio?
Yeah, they got robbed.
Yeah, and and when I worked there, you know, X used to come through that studio.
Tentacion, right?
Yeah, and all those guys that he hangs out with, they used to all work at that studio. And these guys used to come in with on so many different drugs that they didn't even know their names. And somehow I had to make sure that they were in their sessions and make sure that they were good. And to see that, this is 2014. I'm 28 now. I was young. Mm-hmm. I didn't know mollies and all types of shit. Like,
yeah,
you know, to see stuff like this. And that's really what it reminded me of. The darkness that I saw being in that studio.
Yeah.
That's what that song reminded me of. So that's why I was just like, it made me lightheaded.
Okay. Huh. All right.
But so it took you to a place.
It took you to the Tentacion style of audience.
Yeah.
Okay. So you would say that it wouldn't be for you, but it would fit in a Tentacion style audience.
It has, exactly. But for me personally, because I've had that experience, it would be different for me to like listen to that.
Okay. Mark.
He says a lot of his stuff comes from that place. So interesting.
All right. So how you feel about it, Alex? Where you at with it?
I need to do more drugs.
We don't suggest people do drugs on
No, we do not. I'm not for that.
I don't know. It's good to hear that he's back. I feel like I could pick out things that he was saying, but also too, I heard a fairly clean vocal chain. Some effects.
It had some effect code on the whole thing.
On the whole thing, which I think at this point, based on what we've heard from him, I think that was on purpose. Now. Yeah. And which is a good thing. Now he's not stumbling into, I made this crazy sound. Now he's like, I want to make this crazy sound. And I think that to me, I think that speaks loudly. I still think that he's got to kind of work on the low end and get it hitting. But I also think that that comes from the studio environment that he's mixing in. But I feel like it's very space shit. I feel like, you know, he's for us, he's been here for a while, so we've gotten to see his growth.
Yeah, and I can't read anything that he writes,
he still can't.
So, like, it's
what do you mean you can't read it?
I can't read what,
he
like,
speaks
is
his own
it
language.
Old me no fur?
Yeah,
like, if you were like, yo, that what song is that? You'd be like, bruh. It's one of Space Jam songs, and then you have to go through his whole catalog to find the song you like. And I make fun of names and song names and stuff on the stream all the time. But I'm also trying to make a point with that. It's like, yeah, okay, this is creative, but to the average person, they can't find it. They can't look it up. They'll have to look up Space Jam, and then. If they would have to go through his whole catalog, and then by that time they may give up.
That's what I was gonna say. He actually does have like a big platform that he could like push his music through.
Yeah,
and that he just has to do it properly because there is a platform for this. There is a way to like really blew up, and that it's just a matter of like him understanding that like us, like me, I'm not gonna listen to this, but there are people that's gonna listen to that.
Yeah, Tiffy was on the stream 3 weeks and she said her favorite artist that submits to the stream is Space Jit.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he just happened to not be on the stream that
you
day.
Missed that Space Jit. Omino. If you know, you know. Okay. All right.
That's what that means?
Omino. No, it's like it's more like a if you know, you know. It's a couple from an anime.
Oh.
How do I get it? It's cool, but who's gonna find it? And if they do, who's gonna fuck with it? What?
He's like, how does he find what crowd? What audience are you talking about? How does he find it? Or what platform are you talking about?
So you know how some people like in his video he has those girls that
the anime elf girls.
Girls. There's literally an entire generation of people that all they do is watch that and that's all they know. Like he has to find a way to get it into those realms of things. And I think if he does that, he's gonna be good. And they spend money.
Stuff like that, I feel when it comes to TikTok, and I'm not even an avid user of TikTok. I barely use TikTok, but I feel as it's once you set your algorithm, it forces you into a group of people that fit you. So that's why, I mean, we constantly push like, oh, do this stuff on TikTok on the stream. If you make these videos and put them on TikTok and have the correct hashtags, the hashtags that are similar to the other people doing this stuff, it's going to start putting these videos in that community. And then that community is going to be like, yo, this is music I'll listen to while I'm watching this, playing this, whatever. I don't know what it is. It reminds me of like old VR chat style of things. So it reminds me of like old VR chat stuff.
He says something interesting and it gives me a thought. He says, no, I'm saying whoever will find it will fuck with it heavy. And it's like, but how do you find it? It's a discovery process. So he's creating a discovery process for people. But let me put something out to you, Space Jit. Put out a song that's like, to you, it feels least common denominator. It's almost some of your more basic stuff. That way, when people do find that and you put yourself out to a very broad market, it begins the rabbit hole search of what else has he done? And then they discover, oh my gosh, this catalog is deep. There's a lot. I know that you're releasing stuff like every week. So give something to the people so that way you can lure them in so that they can go down that process of discovery.
So there's a very interesting Atlanta episode in this recent season that where Paperboy is going around, he's listening to an artist and he just found out that artist died. And that artist in his mixtape is sending people on a scavenger hunt to figure out where his funeral is. And at the end of it, nobody's there. but that's what he wanted. He wanted people to go on these hunts to find a deeper meaning and all of that stuff. But at the end of it, nobody was there.
Nate the Great.
That's what we're here for. One thing I know artists go through is they go through that period of time of releasing songs for themselves, which is great. It's lovely. But then you have to get into that time where you have to release songs for your consumers and the people that are buying and the people that are, you know, spending money on what you do. So I think once you get to that space of creating music for other people and not just because, you know, this is where you're at right now, you want to make stuff that makes you feel good or a release, then you probably find like, I don't know, like your people, your crowd.
Yeah.
Because now you're making songs for them.
Yeah. And I was referencing Blue Blood. So that's the Atlanta episode. Like literally, like exactly what Space Jit said
that one.
Is fun for him.
Right.
That's exactly what was going on in that entire episode. It was about that. And it was showing that, you know, some people, because he loved the art of what he was doing.
Right.
And it's like, all right, at some point, like
give something
you need something that's going to break and for me I'm like at least spelling
well like no but I get it like I it's a brand thing no, it, I just yeah, feel like
you can still do that but spell it on the side spell it
just give them one space shit
I mean
just give them one
but
just
may,
give
I mean
one
I guess that is an anime
translation
I guess that's an anime code I don't
know right. Can you say X name
XXXTentacion
see not everybody can say it though
most people say X, but
exactly. Yeah.
But they can't say it
wrong.
But they can Google it. They can look it up. How do you this isn't even grammatically, phonetically, hooked on phonically correct. Like, if you type it in Google to say it, it would be like, ah-ha. Like, this isn't even how you would pronounce this. Wait, what did he say? Oh, oh, me. What does it say?
What is it? Something. It's up
it
there.
It says next song.
All right, no, but,
I'm sorry.
Jesus. I mean, somebody just said they love how in depth we go. He's, Alex is over here. Next song.
Next but, song. We're spending 45 I'm minutes for a song. No, it's not you at all.
No, that's what we normally do. But
it's good to see you back, Space Jet.
All right. Moving on, since we're interrupted.
Ain't that Elon's son's name?
Yeah, I don't remember his name. Isn't it like Mouse Cop or something like that? Like the symbol?
Yeah, XAE. I don't know. Yeah, Dash like 29 or something. I don't know.
Oh, thank you. I try my best.
All right. I got a compliment. Yeah, no, you're going to get the compliments. You're getting all of them.
Should have sent the complete song. yeah, that AE some.
Isn't it like an apostrophe? Yeah. And three X's inside the E?
I don't know.
Like they're both, all the letters
inside
are combined.
E.
Yeah. Oh, thank you for following us. 50 Shades of Nate.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, is that you, Nate the Great? Yeah, cool. Appreciate it.
All right, so up next we got Viuda. Viuda sent over a track called Magenta. Jesus, it's Magenta. God,
you're still speaking
no,
space
I'm trying Genese. To, yeah, I'm trying to speak space Genese. Space Genese. But this track's called Magenta. He sent over a love letter. He says, "Yo, what's up, man? How's it going? This is an unfinished track of mine that's going to be on my next project. Hopefully this takes you back. It's all old school slow jams. Much love." All right. Do y'all want me to get started on projects and albums? And no?
Okay. No, not all today. Right.
So let's listen to this track by Viuda. It is called Magenta.
Weatherman dance on a song called Blue. I guess it's about colors today.
True.
All right.
This was like in the beginning of every softcore porn from like the from like the 80s, 90s. This is like right when the credits are rolling. I could beat it for you, girl. Lay your head down.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. You gotta get somebody's grandma
then,
on this.
Then a rainbow color title comes
Listen
up on the screen.
Here. That shit took me to the 80s.
No, we don't do any skip line or anything like that. And there's a there's reasons why, but we'll listen to this review and we may get into it. The same it was a couple days ago.
Bass and that synth are 80s.
Let it breathe. Yes. Oh, the way you make me feel. Oh, daddy, please.
It's raining outside.
Oh, you better not go down there. Please, don't stop me. Ooh. I hope you stay in my mind all the time. Ooh, yes. Oh.
John, you gotta go.
Please make it stop.
Kim's gonna break the stream again.
Oh. 50 Shades of Nate. You've always
that song
been on
goes
my mind.
With his name. Yo, you are nasty.
Pitch it down an octave and slow down.
My name is 50 Shades of Nate, and I'm about to slow it down for you tonight.
I think that's all the song needs.
Yep. This is against Twitch guidelines.
Come on,
you James. You gotta add a heavy breath talking bridge.
Right, that's all you need right there.
Daddy, what are you doing? Please stop it.
In the video, it has to be like you have to dress up like you're in the 80s.
There it is.
With
the full suit.
The full suit, and mm-hmm. somewhere it has
hey,
to rain.
BBLs are outside. Okay.
Is this the rainwater coming down?
This needs a saxophone. Yeah. Where's Nick?
Oh, yeah, it does need a
this
saxophone.
This needs a saxophone.
He has
on
the,
it.
Like, with the rain pouring. No, he's in the shower. It has to be all white towel shower. Uh-huh. So it looks so out of place.
Just like and leaning then, against it.
Yeah, and like, just.
I can be there for you, girl. Every single night.
I just can't. I can't believe your name is 50 Shades.
Oh no, that's not. No, this is Viuda. So this song is Viuda. 50 Shades of Nate is.
He's
oh,
our new
somebody
friend,
else. Okay. Yeah. Oh yeah. Gosh. I'm sorry.
Hey, baby girl, how about you come back to my place, type beat?
Right. Yeah.
I do like this chord.
I love this. Oh. I love it.
That I do love it.
That chorus is awesome.
Yeah,
that chorus is amazing.
Hey man, I need that. This is what I need to.
Is it, what's the is the picture Midnight Moods?
Yeah,
it is what it is.
I love
this.
It.
And I do have a magenta light at my house.
Yeah,
we have magenta
I can
lights.
Put
behind
that
us.
To use.
All right.
All right.
So that was I really liked it. It brought me back to the 80s, and you know, there's not a lot of songs nowadays that does that. That bass was great.
Yeah.
And the fact that we can do all of this to the song and have fun with it, that's a plus.
Yeah.
I think like this where the beat's breathing here, like where there's nothing here. Where I was doing all the talking. I kind of like having a little bit of that there. So it's almost like a fill in the blank while whatever you're doing while you're listening to this.
It did kind of go for a little bit.
Yeah, it went too long.
I feel like it would need. It could be filled with something.
Like, I think he could start it with, like, ooh, mm-hmm. why are you touching me? You know, start it like that or whatever. Something cool. Have a girl talk. I don't know. Have it. And then it go to, like, letting it breathe, like, right here. And it can be, like. And then in the background. Yeah, and then right
hit
here.
Hit with that saxophone.
Hey, baby girl. You're always on my mind. Drew Hill style. Yeah. Take a walk with me.
That kick and the bass and the synth all at the same time. It's the most 80s thing I've heard in a long time.
So I think talk a little bit, breathe with saxophone,
mm-hmm.
ad libs in the back, and then go back when his break comes in. Do that talking. And then boom, back into the chorus.
Sax and sex is all it needs.
Yep. Sax and sex.
There it is.
That's about right.
So cool. If you run into Nick is in the Discord. See if Mr. Altiz Moto would give you some saxophone on that, man.
It's his thing.
Yeah. He has all the microphones and everything. He's ready to record saxophone.
Yep.
That is one thing he wants to do.
And he lets everybody know it.
He is always down to record some saxophone.
Yeah.
And he's good too. He's really.
I think he could really nail that screaming 80s like solo.
Yeah.
He usually plays a little bit like pull back, but I think he could really nail that. Mm-hmm. It's a low pitch, slow reverb. All right. Thanks for submitting. That's on what's coming up next. That's the next thing that you're working on.
Where the next project he's working on, because he releases projects, not songs.
I think John would probably do that.
What?
You said you had the magenta lights.
Oh. Oh, because Amp's asking who recording the sex.
Recording the sex.
All you got to do is ask, little daddy. I'm here for you. If you need me, you can follow me on OnlyFans.com. /Instagram/IM. My OnlyFans is my Instagram.
I got it. Yeah. You be putting the thirsty traps in there.
No, I don't.
It. Yo, every time John has an event or he has a flyer to drop.
So hey, thanks for submitting.
Thank you for noticing, Jen. Hold up, Jen. Wait, say what you're
wait,
about to
wait,
say.
Wait, what? Wait,
say,
what?
Say what you're about to say because I do this on purpose.
Every time John has an event or he has a flyer to post, he do a little thirsty drop. You know, he'll put the little shirt out, a couple pictures, and, you know, little smiley yep. faces. Because, mm-hmm. you know, the girls are going to look.
My numbers triple.
Triple.
Mm-hmm. Triple when I do that. Post anything.
You pull like a little gym pic, him mm-hmm. lifting at mm-hmm. the gym.
Showing all these assets.
And then he'll post them flyers. Yep. Come to this event. Got you. You can see this in person.
Oh, I know how my algorithm works.
It's okay. I do the same.
Yep. You got to, because nobody cares about us.
It's just how Instagram works.
They just want
now.
Us for our bodies. That's what it is.
Instagram exactly. just wants us for yeah. our bodies.
Jesus.
Oh.
All right. Up next, I know Mustafa was here. I think yeah, he's still here just silently. But we got Mustafa. He sent over a track called No Blame. He didn't send a love letter or anything. So let's check this track out. No Blame. Hollywood Tay Bounce, huh? Well, Hollywood Tay Bounce. Oh, is this going to be New Orleans Bounce? Or is it going to be Jersey? Or is it going to be Philly? It's sounding very Philly.
Are we dropping frames?
Oh. I can't place no blame. Just working on me and I'm getting my bread up.
Wow.
My nigga okay. turned to a traitor. Used to be a G, but he turned to a hater. I wanna roll his ass up, turn a nigga to a viper. I should've already knew low key. That was all on me. I can't place no blame. Just working on me.
Is it clipping? Is the whole thing just peaked out by the over compression?
Something
is happening. I don't think there's a limiter on the master.
It's just loud. Yeah, I don't think there's a limiter.
Everything
on the
is really at the ceiling, just like stressed.
Let's hear it.
And I'm getting my bread up. Ooh, right my there. Mind weary, heart bitter. Look what they done in my city. I don't want pain, but I don't want pity. Yeah, glitter, but it ain't gold. I keep it in mind. It's time to die. Just working on me and I'm getting my bread up. Keeping my head up, one day at a time, making my bed up. A nigga so fed up, ready to pop like a perk. Anxious sweet might pop at your head. All in my bag, pulling out bread, sharpen my skills. It cut off the edge, all in her belly, I'm getting that jelly.
Spreading that nut,
her man on the celly. I'm with his girl, and she on my dick. Hung up the phone, thought we was alone. I hit the door, all with that blick. I just wanted to hit, I don't even like that bitch.
I can't place no blame.
Just working on me and I'm getting my I've been on a mission.
Wasn't expecting that, but I like when a girl I wasn't expecting that. That reminds me of some old Trick Daddy and Trina stuff. But it sounds like these vocals about to come in very Nate, crazy.
I'll answer that in a second.
What is going on?
It's just
it's proximity effects mixed with compression.
It's just everything. All of the lows and all the mids like are at their peak of not being able to be held by the bounce, essentially.
Huh.
Cheese, they be grilling. Staying by my side, you the realest. They already know what I'm doing.
Like, I almost feel like this whole thing would need to be re-recorded.
I think it's a mix issue. I think it's the mixes. You remember a couple weeks ago?
On a microphone. It sounds like it's microphone peak.
I don't think it is. I really think it's a mix. You remember a couple weeks ago when we talked about, like, using a beat and then trying to match
yeah.
the level of the beat. I think that's what's happening here.
I think,
like,
yes,
it's just so loud.
It almost sounds yeah. like they're so close to the microphone that it is a microphone peak issue as well as the mix.
Let me hear some more.
Just working on me and I'm getting my bread up. I've been doing me, you do the same. Me and you ain't never been in lanes. I feel you wrong forever, take the blame.
Like, it sounds like I can't even do it because this microphone is not, the gain isn't up high enough. But if I turned the gain up on this and got really close, it has that, it almost That's sounds it. Like the microphone is about to, the capsule is about to blow.
I've been winning, never play the game. I know it hurt to hear them say my name. But look, I can't play some blame. Just working on me, I'm getting my bread up. Head down, keeping my head up. They ever get me wrong and they deserve it.
That
I just had to learn ain't nothing perfect. Everything may look good on the surface. I've been only chasing shit
but
that's worth
it. It also could just be slammed against the ceiling of the... I mean, he says it's a loud bounce, and I feel like this is like a no limiter, all at zero bounce.
teach me lessons, so I'm learning. The more lessons, more that I'm earning. More money making, more money burning. Time ticking, watch keep turning. I stay hot, I'm a furnace. I remember I ain't have a dollar. Now I don't have to think about the purchase. Everything I got, I work for. Everything I got, I know I earn it. Blank. Just working on me, I'm getting my bread up.
All right, I think that's it. Okay.
All right. Nate asked a couple good questions. Like, could this kind of sound be achieved without the need for it to be slammed, essentially? And yeah, absolutely. You could use, you mentioned like a saturator, some kind of like distortion. Like, it's not against the rules to just use distortion. In fact, if you do distortion properly in a weird, fun physics like world that we live in, you're actually going to get a little bit more headroom by distorting it. So, and also it would give you that control. I'm going to stick to what I was saying before. I really think that it's like the beat was a certain level and then they just brought the mix up to that level of the beat, even though the beat was like kind of mastered and the vocals aren't mixed. So they're just trying to slam these vocals, these unmixed vocals, at the level of a beat that's mastered. So it's just loud. That's what I have to say.
Jen?
So I think the whole song will need to be re-recorded, me personally. I also think that like the girl is good. She just had very low energy. Like the whole song needs to be re-recorded with more energy and the whole mix needs to be redone. Like something is wrong. That's why I was just like, I had to take my headphones out because I couldn't sit there and listen to it, to be honest. But yeah, that's all I have to say.
All right. So shouts out to Mustafa. I said everything I had to say throughout the song. Yeah, all the pausing I was doing. That's what I said it. So
fair.
I think I need to go next door. I think I need to turn the sub up.
I was hearing that.
It sounds like it could be the music they're playing is surprisingly.
You could just not turn the sub up. Yeah. Because you know that the second you give them that control, that wall's coming down.
Yeah. But I don't know if they've played anything that has low end today.
Deep lows? Yeah. No, I don't know either.
And they also haven't texted me, so I don't know what's going on. But maybe they have.
Everybody that works next door is like, oh, it sounds so nice in here. I'm not going deaf. The bass isn't at 5,000 decibels.
Yeah. All right. So, yeah, shouts out to Mustafa for sending that over. That track was called No Blame. Up next, we got Jalen Versus the World. He sent over a track called Glory. I think there's two. No, there's a song called Glory and Gushy today. So I'm getting a lot of G's. All right. So Jalen Versus the World sent over a track called Glory. Absolutely no love letter. Let's check this out. It is on his SoundCloud. Kim, if you could throw a SoundCloud on the screen, that would be lovely. He uploaded this 5 days ago.
Ooh.
Let's check it out.
Hey, let's go. I'm doing shows. I'm on the road. I stack my bread. I count my roll. I'm doing great. Now you know. I'm gonna glow. I'm doing shine on the road. I stack my bread. I count my
road. Yeah, Nate, you're just all you're. You should have to scroll down for you to see your name. You're at the. You're a little bit further down.
I'm doing great. Now you know. I'm gonna shine. I'm gonna glow. New song. New flow. New friends, new bros, can't bend, can't fold, I win, and you know, I like the night sky, that's my favorite color, oh you don't like me, you hate undercover, oh you want smoke or something, okay that's fine,
I'm doing shows, I'm on the road. I stack my bread, I count my roll. I'm doing great, now you know. I'm gonna shine, I'm gonna glow. I'm doing shine, on the road. I stack my bread, I count my roll. I'm doing great, now you know. I'm gonna shine, I'm gonna glow.
All right, that was Jalen versus the World, or JV. That track is called Glory, produced by Sammy Boy.
Huh. Amp said it. His mixing is better. I agree with that. His mixing is better.
You guys heard him before?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Is that a good oh, yes, or a bad oh, yes?
It just depends.
Let me hear it.
That oh yes.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
You know it is what it is. How do you feel about
Eclipse? There you go.
Every single week. Yeah. Okay, so I guess every single week you guys tell him to get his mix better.
We'll go with that.
Other things.
I don't like the writing, but I like the direction. And the inspiration, I think that someone said it, like, you know, maybe get a writer or maybe have better life experiences. Go live your life and write about that instead. Because if you're not doing shows and getting paid and it doesn't sound right in your song, then it's not going to make sense. I think a lot of times you just need to have, like, life experiences to make better music. And I don't know. I like the way like that it's going. I just don't like what it's being said. I think you could use better words. I don't know if I'm saying that in a
valid.
Mean way.
No, very valid. Yeah, you said it.
Oh, hey.
Oh my gosh, you guys are like really bad.
What did I do? I didn't even do anything. I haven't even said anything.
You made me feel bad.
No. You're good.
What you said generally parallels what you says every single week. Okay. So,
all right,
that's
I'm accuse you.
But see, now
me.
He's gonna listen.
The mix wasn't the mix was a slightly better. I don't want to give him a lot of room in that area because it's still the same effects.
Right.
The same.
Like it was a little bit spacier.
Which
typically he stacks a lot of stuff and it gets really kind of lost, but. This one had some space. Now, it did repeat itself in terms of effects over and over and over.
Yeah.
So you could be creative in that respect, but I'm glad to see that you're moving in a realm where the effects are spacing out a little bit.
I'm indifferent to this one. I'm indifferent to this one. I don't have anything to say. The mix is slightly better than other things.
Valid.
Amp said, don't say that you say this every single week.
See, that's what I'm saying.
What? What did I say? I haven't said anything.
I don't know.
She said what you normally say.
Yes, that's what I heard.
I didn't even say that. So, so what are y'all talking about? That's how I feel about that song.
You should go to some mosh pit shows. You know, like those mosh pitting shows that be happening at Hanau.
Not like he's a very Yachty, early Yachty-esque style person and Gracie's Corner style of person. You ever heard of Gracie's Corner?
Yes.
Like the kids stuff. Yes. Like it's like that, but he's not. His songs aren't all for kids, so it's almost like adolescent style of Gracie's Corner. So it's almost like if Teen Titans was Gracie's Corner.
I feel like that's kind of mean.
No, it's not. Man, have you listened to some of the Teen Titans songs that Beast Boy would be saying?
They are ripping.
Fire. I feel he's getting to, like, he's very cartoonish. And that can be fine. I think he could be on Nickelodeon. Like, if it was a...
Nah.
If it could get there eventually. That's how I feel. But with this, I'm just like, meh. Yeah. Meh. He's doing shows.
That's kind of what she just said. It's like
Take a break.
Go take a break.
Go live
some life. Yeah.
You have more to talk about then. Maybe you talk about, you know, your creative process. I don't know. Do something.
How you know I don't do shows? Uh-oh.
I'll say that as somebody that does shows and makes pretty decent living from doing shows, a lot of the people that are performing at shows
don't make a song about doing shows.
They don't
make
a song about shows, and they also don't make a song that sound like that. I'm just saying.
Damn. No, I know, right?
No,
for real, most people who are doing shows won't be like, I'm doing shows, unless they will say a phrase about it. Like, if it's in the Travis Scott thing, and he's like, he'll say something about something that happened at a show, but he won't be like, I'm doing shows.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, it'll be like mosh pit going crazy.
Yeah, something like that. Or like how they sold out a show or something. I don't know. Yes. It just really depends.
Yeah. Okay. Wrong show. I mean, maybe he's doing other shows.
I want to know what kind of shows you're doing.
OnlyFans. I might not be in the stream when you get to my song because work an hour, but I'll definitely be here when I'm rocking with y'all. Well, what we normally do, if you're not, we do a roll call towards the end of the stream, and then the people who aren't here, we'll skip past them. So hopefully you are here.
I think he's going to hang out. Yeah. He's doing movies.
All right. So Eclipse is up next. So shouts out to JV or Jalen vs. the World.
Thank you for submitting
for
as
that
always.
Track called Glory. Yep. Eclipse up next with a song called Yak What WTF.
We're gonna be after this show.
We have mentioned it a bunch today, and he's wondering, are we sponsored by OnlyFans?
Facts. We're gonna be after this show.
No, I mean, OnlyFans is Instagram now. You can y'all can subscribe. I haven't even set it up. I'm not going to, but
what do you mean by you haven't?
No, yeah, I'm not going to, but You can subscribe to somebody's Instagram like OnlyFans.
You can. That's wild.
Yeah, because they got tired of people. So OnlyFans girls were doing it on Instagram where they would put them in their close friends. And you would have to pay the Instagram girl to be in her close friends. And Instagram was like, nah, we need to make our cut.
Uh-huh.
So Instagram did the subscribe thing. But shouts out to the women for finessing. shouts out to them.
Yeah,
close friends
make that money.
Yeah, and but what a lot of women were charging men to be in their close friends, and they had OnlyFans as well.
I should have thought of that hustle.
Yeah, that's what I said. Shouts out to them. But Instagram was like, "Oh no, we know if y'all
money
doing this
is happening without us."
Yep,
not today.
Yep. So shouts out to them. But this track is called "You Already Know What the Fuck Is Going On" or "Yak WTF Go."
Shit.
This is by Eclipse. He sent over this track. He said, "You're just dropped a remix of the homie from Texas, Fiona the Don. I swear to God, he is up next. This whole catalog is fire and strongly encouraged." I actually like this song. I've heard this before.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I like this one. So I'm biased. I'm not reviewing it. This is fire. Let's listen to it.
All right.
Like a wolf, cause I'm eating. Yeah. People say I'm a little conceited, but that's just because they don't see what I'm seeing. I'm the big top dog, so I really don't like when the lame niggas speak when I'm speaking. Yeah. I went back to the block and I made triple profit this week. It ain't even the weekend. Yeah. They've been waiting for Don to come back and deliver the news. You would think I was Jesus. Yeah. Got the world on my back, keeping the strap in my lap. I be fighting all homies. Yeah. Said he wanna come see about the Don, but he ain't see the Don when that nigga stopped breathing. Yeah. Talking down on the net, now he down 6 feet. Everybody like, what was he dead? If that boy really tough when he rap. Shouldn't known all that talking was cat. Let's red light, green light, stuck on the strap. We play red light, green light, get wet. Proud of the game, cause it's been a minute since we stretched down the block just to kick through a door. Changed my name to a different level, got my dogs out the street, now we up. Thank the Lord. Too many pleasures to make every day that I wake, so I never got time to be bored. And every time I get involved with a bitch, she be wasting my love, ain't got time for no more. I came up on the block, but I'm different. I might cop the demon and add on some butterfly door. Everybody like, how does he do it? I don't pay attention, I just keep my eyes to the floor. I took over the block, but it wasn't enough. I kept eating shit.
shit up, I'm always...
The only note I'll add to this is that the vocals just need to be a little bit louder and brought some more to the front. I know Eclipse made the beat, and I know dude probably sent him the vocal stems. I just think the vocal, because the beat is like very how Eclipse does his drums, where it's like negative 0.001 on the limiter. So it's like just barely not clipping, but the vocals are buried. So you kind of got to struggle to listen. But if this was in like a bass competition, your car would sound crazy.
Right.
It would sound fire. But I would want the vocals to match that because then it'll feel complete. But yeah.
It's fair. All I associate with and these lame ass niggas still living like dorks. Walk down, baby, we gon' step like a porch. Whole team on my back while I carry the torch. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just letting it play. I like the beat.
I'm curious if like the kick hits so hard and it takes up so much frequency space that I'm curious
with the Pulp Fiction sample. Go ahead.
Oh yeah. If it'd be hard to, you'd have to find a sweet spot to sidechain compress the vocals into the kick or pick one of those lines, because like when the other stuff came in, it was just all like reacting to the tail of the kick, which sounded really cool. But I feel like if you chose one of those lines and then made it the key trigger to the compressor on the kick to just slightly move out of the way of the vocals to just let the vocals shine through and not necessarily be interrupted by the wobble of that kick, then I feel like it would bring the vocals to the front while still maintaining a space for the kick to just hit really fucking hard. And that's really my only thought on it, is like just separate those two just a little bit. It might even... I'm being super technical, but it might, what up, Nan? It might even need to be like an EQ, that sits on the kick that's right where the vocals are. So it's hitting, it's wobbling, but it's also just not, it's just not, not interrupting those vocals as much. And that's my only other thought. I'm sure I could raise the volume without the vocals sounding on top. I think if you do what I'm talking about, you'll find that it makes the space for that, for those vocals. That's my thoughts. That's all I have to say.
My thoughts are that I like the song. It made me want to go to the gym.
Okay.
Right. I don't know. I've
been trying to get Eclipse in the gym, but he's scared to go.
Really?
Yeah, he's scared to go with me.
He needs to listen to his own music.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it. I really do like it. I would say that the vocals and the beat are kind of like separated a little bit. So it kind of needs to either be like equally in the same levels. And that's like what you guys were talking about. Other than that, I like it. I don't have any like specifics.
Okay.
Other than that. That's fair.
Yeah.
That's fair.
And Eclipse is scared to go to the gym. All right.
the review of the song is...
In my head, I did this with my biceps. I was like, yeah. Like, I don't know. That's how I felt.
Fair.
Nice. Yeah. I will say it again. Eclipse is scared to go to the gym.
You're right. I'm going to let you have that one. You probably have some small legs. Because you don't squat.
Who, me? Or are you talking about Eclipse?
Him.
Oh,
got them chicken legs.
Chicken legs. They don't match with your whole body.
Yeah.
Do you wear long pants all the time?
Actually, I'm pretty sure.
I think we're on to something.
Yeah, how are you reading this, man?
so you can hide your Chick-fil-A.
No. I think if he's squat, he'll probably be very strong at squat. But
I'm messing with you.
He don't even have to hang with me at the gym. He could just go. He could just sit. He could just go and do the exercises.
Now you guys do be in the gym for a long time though.
Not really.
Chicken legs.
Not really. Chicken legs. We just be hanging out.
Yo, you ever seen those big body people, but like their bottom part is just don't make no sense?
Yeah, in the gym all the time. All the time. Exactly. And they're always doing arms or chest or shoulders. And it's like, bro,
you look weird.
Do
legs.
Fix it.
Do something. Don't do that.
Don't do that.
He said, like, they literally sleep in the gym. I'm building a home gym.
Then you'll be sleeping at the gym.
Right.
Amp goes, ask Amp. Eclipse, Amp's made it. And Amp's be hanging out with us at the gym.
Listen, if I have time to go to the gym, everybody have time to go to the gym.
All right. There it is. Well, it sound like some, I was about to say, who got some Doritos?
She got snacks.
Uh-huh. All right, lady wearing that brown dress out there. Right? Yeah. Come on, right? All right,
that
thank you.
Sitting.
Okay.
That
thing. All right. That thing was stacked up out there.
It was sitting.
Yep. All right.
Pound cake.
At least I got somebody here with me who can legally talk about it. Alex would get in a lot of trouble with me.
I'm very aware of the situation.
It was a nice pound cake.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. All right. Up next, the last track was by Eclipse. It's called You Already Know What the Fuck Going On. So shouts out to him for sending that over. Up next, we got Maceo sent over a track called, is it Maceo or Maceo?
It's Maceo.
Maceo.
Is it?
We also don't pronounce names around
I've
here.
I've called him Maceo for like 17 years.
And he hasn't corrected us.
Never
I'm
corrected.
I'm sure that like in the back of his head, he's probably thinking like, motherfucker, get my name right.
That's like if somebody called me Juan Q.
Juan Q?
I would be like, it's John. To John
Hanifa.
He's never corrected me ever.
It's Maceo.
Maceo.
Yes.
Not Masango.
No.
We're definitely gonna forget that as soon
it's
as
like
the stream
Masego.
Is over.
But without the Maceo. S and the G,
Maceo,
and the silent apostrophe over the E.
Maceo. How can you not P. say that? You're just being.
Oh,
stubborn.
You can say May. There's no E. I guess Maceo. Yeah. If there was an E, it would be Maceo.
See, he said, things don't stick with us. I told you like once and it never stuck, so I didn't correct you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds accurate.
That actually does.
I guarantee you it's going to be Maceo as soon as the stream is over.
Yeah.
Forever. Forever. Just accept
it. I don't blame you guys because there's so many names that I literally cannot say when I'm hosting. I just be like, what the fuck? Like, what you think?
What is this?
What
name?
Was happening when you came up with this shit? What's your legal name?
I butcher everybody's name anyway. I just make up names for people. So if I can't pronounce it, it's just.
I'll spell that shit out. Z-Y-E-N-A-H.
I used to have to do that because Eclipse had apostrophes in every single letter of his name. So it was.
Jeez. I think people have to get better at like creating artist names.
Oh, SoundCloud names are SoundCloud names.
Oh boy.
Yeah. All right. So Maceo.
Thank you.
All right.
Don't forget.
Sent over a track called, I know I said what it was called, Untitled. So he said, wanted to share a video I dropped a few months back. So I missed and mastered it. Still learning. I directed and edited the video as well. Hope y'all enjoy it. And y'all better be at the Fusion Awards on Hood. So
put a pin in that because we're going to talk about that.
Yeah, we haven't announced that because Jen hasn't told me if we're doing it.
I did you that I made you a flyer.
Oh, I didn't get it.
I thought I sent it.
Mm-mm, you be neglecting.
Listen, I have like a lot of messages.
Jen never writes me back. I just want everybody on this stream to know that we are now.
I'm not even going to start because... We're going to have to shut this shit down.
We are on record. Jen does not write me back. She writes me, and I will respond, and then she will never write me back until she writes me again, and I will respond, and then she'll show up, like today. I wrote her today, like, hey, this is what's going on. She never wrote back. She was just here.
She's just here.
She never writes me back.
I read your message and I'm here.
Exactly. But
no need for a reply.
He said it's not no just need. You.
It's just wasted effort.
It is. And then,
Mateo, come on.
And then she'll hit me up and be like, hey, stranger. You still haven't wrote me back.
I'm sorry.
Yep.
I'm not the best. I think people don't understand that, like, I feel like if I'm talking to you on social media and you're texting me, then that cancels out that conversation.
That's fair. I don't want to hear no excuses.
But John is the worst because you can only talk to him on social media.
That's not true anymore.
So if he texts you, it's probably raining outside.
It's not true anymore.
Or something horrible.
My new phone now has everything I get. So my social media, everything turns up as a chat bubble. So now that's why I responded on social media quicker, because it was chat bubbles. But now this does it to my text messages, to my social media and everything. So now I don't have
to
open an app.
You have to pay attention.
Yeah, I don't have to open an app to respond to every message platform.
That's...
Shout out to Google Pixel.
Really cool.
He still don't text back. And then he'd be double texting you all day.
He double texts.
No, that was my old phone.
Oh, yeah.
I think that was in the transition because of the way I had to change, like switch my number over. I was on two cell phone services.
I had to message him and say, you're doing it again and you have to restart this phone.
I'm tired of it.
Yeah. No, it isn't doing it anymore, is it? It shouldn't.
No, you're good.
Because I switched over cell service people and it was in
a
transition.
You just need an iPhone.
Nah, the Pixel is fire. All right, so up next, Amp said he still don't text me. It takes time. All right, so Kim, we're going to have to bring this video up if you have it up. Hey, all right. So, All right, all right, so Kim's going to put the video on screen so you guys can enjoy it while we enjoy
I'm
it.
I'm probably the biggest side bitch of John. I'm the one and only side bitches of John. If there is a side bitch to John, it's me.
Y'all need to chill out.
Anybody likes it or not?
I just don't think people understand how many messages I get. It's like I'm just trying to exist.
Really?
And everybody just wants a piece of me.
That's you?
Yeah, that's supposed to be you.
Oh.
Yeah, that's
me. I guess we're alike.
I was channeling my gin.
You're doing a good job.
Yeah. All right.
Lord.
We ready for this? Lord. All right, count me down.
Not for nothing.
What did Pisces women do? I'm not gonna start this. I'm not starting.
Ray. Ray. Fuck feeling pigeon-held niggas, I just go back to basics. I know my issues in the past and us to distant strangers. And both us hated, been a while and now I feel amazing. But every second consuming, and every which shit that I doom, it seems I'm losing patience. I've been on top, but I feel as if I live in a basement. Smooth killer, that nigga, bitch, most get a bullshit right. That they say about me, probably real. If I hung over the bitches, then them bitches would kill. It's too real. Now why you talking about them places you ain't been nowhere? Man, this journey feels so endless when you stacking stairs. It's too red. Oh God. Never ever has a nigga vision been so clear.
Oh, is that Stone in the video?
I'm making a bigger room for these wings, my dear. It's too red.
Stone pulled up on me Sunday.
Swear to God, a nigga never been so fucking sure of my life. Pocketbook and revolver. I ain't been out my head. I've been a bit mean, but a bit more manly. Had to raise some standards. Had to cut them seams, cause it seems that respect that meets what's in here in this room. And I only speak to DA does. My mama told me in blood. Keep it proper. Man, wipe them crumbs up off your lap. My nigga, keep it proper. Make them question how you do that. I feel like Dwayne Carter. Can't be human, so who you fooling? Nigga, friends flipping. Hope you miss them. Probably diss them. A nigga too fine. Bitch, to get with it in due time. Bakery cooking, I know they've been looking, but once I get to it, it's showtime. Humble and ignorant, both rhymes. Something like poetry, dog. Side showing, but humbly niggas can't fuck with me, but it's ducking me up to our all the niggas be flying. I told
you know what you know, better show it each day. It's a part of the show. Don't be swayed by the play. There's one thing you should know. All that glitters ain't gold. I hope you find your way and your flower to grow.
What's up, Madeira?
Like, them girls swear he got something he don't got.
Hey, shouts out to SR50, Jai Reynolds.
And then I had to think about it. I was taking a shot. I said, man, funny looking dude. Like, he's gonna be talking trash. Like, for real. Like, I really don't even gotta be messing with him.
Hey, shouts out to Harrison.
Oh, no.
Stone.
Oh,
looking
no.
at the credits. Harrison works at Valencia. He's a professor at Valencia.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
In what department?
Film. He teaches the location sound in film sometimes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Huh.
He was going to move to our department when we couldn't find anybody, but then... Jose took it over.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So shouts out to them. I like, so critiques on the video, since people have asked us, do we do that? Critiques on the video. I feel like he should have had a, like, I don't know if that was shot on an iPhone or something like that, but whatever, that's cool. A Steadicam. So when you're doing the sidewalk walking scene, a Steadicam, you can buy one for your iPhone. You can buy one for whatever camera you have. I think for the iPhone, it's only like $60.
Yeah, it's like nothing.
On Amazon. So it's not a crazy purchase, but it would have made those shots look a little bit cleaner. And the last scene you did on the street corner, I felt like that's the frame, the entire scene of you walking on the street should have been shot in. It was more closer. And I felt like it was a little bit, you were more involved. I really liked how you were doing like the squares with all the behind the scenes. I always love videos like that where it kind of shows your journey or things in the past and the happiness in it. And that just showing the journey.
Yeah.
I always love seeing that in videos because you can see the real life of an artist
and their
circle. Yeah. You can see what it's like behind the scenes and it's not all just these setup photo shoots and setup videos and stuff like that. I appreciate that stuff. I don't know if anybody else, like a regular consumer, does, but I do. So
I think a mixture of having a whole bunch of like glitz and glamour, but sprinkle in some realness, show some authenticity.
Yeah.
I really liked just that background shot. I mean, there was a whole lot of stuff that made sense, made it into a story, but I really liked just the continuous motion. Now whether it could be pulled in a little bit or zoomed out, whatever, but it just kind of stuck with me as like this is a good shot. It just keeps going. It's the whole length of the video.
Another thing that would have been cool is if a new scene, I don't know, like, I mean, what Alex is saying is that continuous shot cool. Mm-hmm. Like another idea would have been like if those scenes that were popping up on the screen became the main focus while the thing walking down the street went into like a picture-in-picture kind of thing. And then they kept like changing,
switching it off
from time to time.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To show like a full screen of this different experience or whatever. But
there was another one where it was like he was standing there and I guess there was a girl next to him and he was just kind of vibing like that. And I kind of was hoping that it would like switch into that and then like the other thing would be between those two it would tell just kind of almost a silly story but then have these other visuals going on. But
sorry, I'm still not sure about that.
Oh
hey Siri.
Hello Siri. The main footage was shot on a cam, no steady cam that day, all the other footage I agree with Q, just some like steady it out for that main shot, but
yeah,
I liked the shot.
Other than that, the concept. I mean, you direct. I
all the music videos I did back in the day, I directed them, and I worked with what I had.
Yeah.
And I always had this grand vision. I was like, okay, how can I make it as close
to
that? And so I really appreciate that. 100%. And I think you're in a, I like, it's a good direction.
Yeah.
Good eye for what you're trying to do for yourself and for your image. And then now about the song, I think the song is good. Great. I actually think the song's great. I think it needs mastering.
I think it needs mastering too.
Because it's a great mix. And it sounds like it's even at the level of a mix, probably like -6 decibels.
Right.
It's not too low. It sounds like, you know, it was mixed and then they put some on the master, but it's still sitting at like -6. A master would bring it up and fill it up.
It was slightly muddy, and I feel like it wasn't muddy in one range. It was muddy in all of. So it the mix is muddy, to say, as opposed to the vocals or the beat or something in the mix. And that's just a mastering thing.
All right. Jen.
I was just letting you guys go.
Jimothy.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, it's gender neutral.
Wow. No comments.
We all have gender neutral names on the street.
I have no comments.
You know.
Alex is gender neutral.
Yeah.
Goes both ways.
Mine's is, what was it, Kim? Jonathy? Or what was it? What was it? I think it was Jonathy.
Wow.
Or something like that.
Jimothy Sanitos.
Kim is Kimothy.
Kimothy. I actually like that one.
And now you're Jenothy.
So I don't think I can say anything because I feel like I'm biased towards Maceo, because I've seen Maceo go from a little witty bitty person to now.
Yeah.
And I've been a part of his process along the way. But I definitely do like the song. And I would say it reminds me a lot of Atlanta, the show.
Yeah.
And
some of those shots that
Some of the shots, the colors, and just like some of the parts that happened in the whole video kind of reminded me of that.
Afro surrealism.
Yeah, I like that. And
I like that.
That's it. That's all I have to say.
Wow, there. Billy Basket Hands.
And Joanna Quinarius. Joanna Quarius. Quinarius.
Jimothy Sanders. I love it. I love it. Oh,
it's the first thing I released that I actually mixed in, really a throwaway track to end an era and start this new Mothman era. Okay. Well, cool. Shouts out to him. Is Mecca? I don't think Mecca's in the building. I haven't seen him.
No.
Mecca from Egypt.
Egypt.
Yeah. It's
but he's not.
Yeah, I don't think Mecca's. I'm going to put MIA on Mecca. The Bliss was here. I think he stopped chatting because the Bliss usually goes silent.
He does. He lurks.
But I think he's still here. So it's about that time to do the roll call. It is 10:30 p.m.
Is it always this long?
Yeah. Yes, it is, Jen. Welcome to the gridiron.
The gridiron.
Everybody's always
the Bliss
like,
is here.
And then when we're like, hey, it's time for us to go, everybody's like, no. And it's like, guys. We've been here for 3 hours.
Gabe is here.
The Bliss is here.
All right. So Bliss is here. I got him checked. Mari's here.
Mari's here. Yeah.
All right. Weather God Dan isn't here, but I promised him I would play this song just because he wants Alex to hear it.
Oh, okay.
And then Gabe is here. Is Hogan Moore the Lord the brother?
The brother.
The brother.
Let me put MIA on
the brother.
Mark made. So Mari sent me a Mark made track, and then Mark made sent me a track. So what do we do?
Jonita Q.
Jonita Q. There's your gender neutral name.
Jonita. Jonita.
Sion is on. My mom went and found all of Sion's music. And now she listens to him. So
okay.
I might do this one for my mother, who is probably watching.
Hi, Mother Q.
Yeah, she doesn't talk in the chat room because she's watching on TV.
Come and say hi to me.
No, she's watching on TV. She never talks in it. She'll probably text or call me. And then Luz. Is Luz here? Madeira was here, so I'm gonna put it here right now.
Did I see Luz briefly? But I haven't seen.
I don't remember. Hey yo, I'm gonna be at Parlay in like 20, so I'm gonna step out here. But I may run into y'all. I mean, we're at 64, so we'll see you walk across the street
and wave.
Parlay. I forgot what parlay does on a Wednesday night.
Take your face and press it right up to the glass.
Yeah. No, I mean, we can let them pop in for a second if you want to pop in, you know. But all right. So, yeah, Nate the Great, I got you. Don't Dang skip lose. All right. So, Amp doesn't want us to skip lose. Okay. So. But all right. So, let's get into this. The Bliss sent over a track. It's called Taken. He said, love letters are against my religion. Warning, made on iPad and GarageBand. Okay.
At least he gave us a warning.
Why are his love letters against his religion? I need to know that.
Maceo, bring a drink.
Oh, yeah. You can. We could step next door and get you a drink.
A spicy margarita.
Word.
Or something.
All right. Let's listen to this one by The Bliss. It's called Taken Draft. Warning, produced on an iPad in GarageBand.
You've been warned.
So with making stuff on GarageBand with like default sounds, mm-hmm. and then especially on the iPad, it's like you can hear the ideas here.
Yeah.
But he needs sounds.
He's openly admitting. He's like, I just did this on an iPad. Yeah.
Yeah. So the idea is cool.
A couple of people really like it.
Yeah. Maceo.
Maceo likes it. No, but you guys listen to like random instrumentals on Spotify when you're working? Is it just me?
No.
I do that. That's something I would listen to.
Interesting.
Yeah, I mean, I listen to instrumental music, like, you know, a lot of that, but...
But there's those focused music?
Oh, I don't know about that life.
No? Yeah, I never looked that
up. I know. Yeah, focus. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
I listen to I'm a Piano.
But it's really just random beats and, like, somebody playing the piano or something.
Yeah, lo-fi hip-hop beats to study and chill to.
There it is.
That's what it reminded me of. Just like that. Okay. You know what's crazy though? I think a lot of people kind of like sleep on stuff like that. Like if you go to Spotify, everybody listens to the sleep music.
Right.
Everybody listens to like.
That's a cheat code to build your YouTube channel. Start it off as a sleep music channel.
Yeah, I think people that don't know how to get into industry or don't know how to break in and make money off their streams or whatever, they should go that route if they're good at it. Like, that shit's easy. It looks easy.
People listen to it all the time.
Yeah. I listen to sleep music almost once or twice a week.
Yeah, like, so that's a cheat. YouTube cheat code is, like, make a 10-hour thing and post it on your YouTube. And your YouTube's going to grow because people are going to subscribe for that one video or whatever. Yeah. And then start doing your own thing.
We're on Twitch. Are we on Facebook today also?
Yes, but nobody's watching on Facebook because Facebook's
terrible.
So,
thanks for swinging by, Nan.
But yeah, so that was about a Bliss. Anything else you want to add with that?
I think it's really cool that there's several people, not just like one or like one, but there's several people that are like, I could do a lot with this. Yeah. I think, Bliss put something in there. I feel like, and I think I've said this before, this is the kind of beat that I feel like you do something and then you send it to somebody and they do something and they send it back and then you alter and you kind of soup up what you did and then send it back and let them do a little bit more and have this kind of, tennis thing going back and forth until you're like, okay, it's there.
Yeah. I do think he'll have to upgrade the sounds and stuff and probably get a computer and use a DAW on a computer.
Right.
Because it would just be way too tedious to try to put sounds on the iPad and put the sounds in the GarageBand and stuff. So I would just recommend get a computer, even with Logic or GarageBand on a computer, you can just go to Reddit, download sounds, sample packs and stuff. Kalen Ellis releases sample packs for free. The Count, there's a bunch of the stuff on Reddit. You can go on Discords and get sample packs and stuff like that. And just then you have better sounds, and then you can make your concepts come to life.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. There's a fire truck.
Yep. And there's the music got turned up a little bit. Yeah. So shouts out to
Life is good.
The subs still aren't hitting. I gotta figure that out. Maybe I gotta mute it. No, they're hitting. It's just there's no boom.
But the walls are still standing.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to go check that out.
Okay.
Up next would be Mari. He sent over a track by Mark May, XL. I think I have this track. Pretty sure I do. So damn, because I need to go over there and make it sound better. I know that. But I want to also sit here for this song.
Why don't we do that? And then
Jen can talk about Fusion and stuff.
And Tim can talk about Fusion.
Yeah. You don't want to?
She like.
you can talk. Y'all, you and Alex can ping pong things off each other. Mm-hmm. And I'll be back and just shifty shakes of shifty shames. Shamishies.
The what?
Yeah.
I don't know
Rick and Morty language. Smosh gone swanskers.
I have ants for eyes.
Water or you want. All right.
I can fight his way to the bar.
All right. I'll be back.
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, now that he's gone.
Oh, we can actually be professional.
So we can actually be professional.
And be real and just, you know,
we can talk about people that wear leggings. Oh, God.
Oh, John.
Can't stand him.
What did she call him? Jonita. Jonita.
I think Nan wants it. I wear leggings. How dare you?
You know, I stopped wearing leggings. I just, the consistent pull up. I can't keep pulling it up. It's
like the effort
I just don't have enough ass to hold it up. Maybe that's what it is.
One of my old friends was like, we're men. We don't have hips.
Right. Like, it's not like, working for me. Like, it just doesn't. I don't wear leggings anymore. But it used to be a time where I would wear that all the time. It's crazy. I see guys wear it a lot.
I mean, I get it. Like, compression shorts are awesome.
They just
help.
It don't be hot.
No, actually, like, I guess it's because technology, like fashion technology, like now everything breathes. Compression is awesome. This man and his audio. Dude.
I mean, maybe it does help. You just may not want the help.
In ways that you don't know.
You know? you know, I don't know.
Showing it's off just, our curves. We're curvy men.
I just wish, you know, I'm 28 and I'm still trying to figure out, like, when does my woman body comes in? And I'm like, when do I get that? You know, growing up, I always heard, like, you get your woman body, like, at some age. And I'm like, when does that, like, start? Like, do I have to press restart or something?
No. When does this thing start?
Right. I'm still waiting. Like, my clothes still fit loose. I still got to wear a belt for everything. Like, it don't make sense.
Yeah.
Nah, I'm good. I'm good.
Thanks for the genetics. Yeah.
I am good. I have a dog, and my dog is like a child, you know? So that's good enough for me. It's just. Yeah, you know what's crazy though? I see a lot of men with a lot of ass, like, and they're not doing nothing with it.
They are not optimizing their situation.
Right. And I'm just like, man, I wish I had them hips.
Are you here first, guys?
What? Them childbearing hips.
If you got it. Do something with it. Don't just be in our chat rooms.
Oh man.
Be doing something with it.
Nah, but I don't have the jeans. I guess I don't have the jeans for it. It's crazy. But I guess John was
just live your life and whatever.
Yeah, I don't think it matters anymore. I think society puts so much pressure on people, women mostly, to like have a certain size of body or a certain size of whatever part. And it's stressful because you kind of like talking about childbearing. Hey,
Julian, what's up?
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
that's what we were supposed to be talking about, but I don't know how we got
childbearing hips. It's an award show for childbearing hips.
Yeah, but
let's talk about the award show.
Yeah, so
what do you got going on?
A couple years ago, I started this thing called the Fusion Awards, and I know, like, one of the things I've talked to John about this, because a lot of times as a woman that's in business, you know, and I don't always have, you know, like that person that can tell me like, hey, you know, take a step back and look at it in that direction, you know, because sometimes when you're running a business, it's just kind of more so like you got to get shit done, you know,
right? Oh,
it doesn't really matter like what's going on in the outside world. Mm-hmm. You have a deadline, you have a timeline you have to stay on, and you have to keep it going.
Yeah.
And when I was talking to John, I'm like, you know, am I doing something wrong with this award show? Like, how is it pissing so many people off? And like, why do so many people have so much shit to say about it?
Right.
And eventually you had to understand that, like, at the end of the day, it's not my job to change anybody's mind or their opinions on what I'm doing. I have to be okay with what I'm doing, and I have to be proud of what I'm doing.
There you go.
Especially if my heart's in the right place.
Right.
And, you know, the awards was originally started because, for those who don't know, I run a show. It's called Fusion & Co., a company called Fusion & Co., and we do the Fusion Showcase. And through the Fusion Showcase, we've been able to create multiple platforms where artists in the city can perform. And I'll see roughly every year we see around 250 to 300 artists that performs on our stages.
Wow.
And that's between multiple shows that we have. So I wanted to do something that was different from, you know, an artist coming to a show and performing. And because, you know, you have this community of people that's coming to the show, it can't always be they're giving you. You have to give them something.
Right.
And the award show was my way of giving them something. And, you know, in the past, it was always the Fusion Award Show, you know, the Fusion Community Award Show, because of the community we built.
Mm-hmm.
But as time went by, you know, so many people were like, oh, you know, why can't it just be Orlando artists? Why does it have to be just Fusion? You know what I'm saying? And I started thinking about, I think I told John this, but I started thinking about, like, with the Grammys, like, you have to be a part of the Grammy,
right?
You know, to get a Grammy, you have to be a part of the Recording Academy thing to get one.
Even to be a judge, you have to be part of
exactly.
it too. Yeah.
So, like, for me, I was just like, but it's the same concept. Like, you have to be a part of this thing to get something that they're investing so much into.
Right.
I can't just give it to somebody that a lot of the people may not know who the hell I am. So, like, why am I just giving people things just because? So that was the original concept. You know, it was for Fusion artists. It was something I wanted to give to artists that we've seen perform over the years.
Mm-hmm.
And it was fun. Now it's not as much fun because I feel like there's a lot more politics around it. There's a lot of more opinions around it because people made it seem as if, like, because I was doing something that was specifically for my platform that I created, I was wrong for doing that, which is kind of fucked up.
Well, and, you know, if they're not going to put any time into
exactly.
it. Yeah.
And, you know, I decided to kind of like opening it up to where, you know, even if you performed at an AMH show, or you guys don't do shows anymore, but any show that happened in Orlando within the time period that we said, you were still allowed or qualified to get an award. And, you know, that kind of like opened everything up for us, because now there's multiple platforms in Orlando that can actually put the artists that perform with them up for an award.
Well, so, we do shows with DJs.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's it. Maybe one day we'll add the artist back.
We're not going to talk about that.
This is the every Sunday it'd be nice.
We like See You Monday, See You Thursday. Those type of events is DJs, different DJs from all over.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. I mean, obviously including me and the regular homies, but we'll always feature somebody, a different DJ. But and because with See You Monday, the AMH Experience, all that stuff, it was supposed to be mainly DJs with artists sprinkled in.
Yeah.
But we've had a couple people performed at See You Thursday back then, but it was because how our style was is we're mixing them into the night. So it's right. a party night,
yeah.
but you're getting mixed in. Your song is getting mixed in. It's your performance track and you're performing it. So where the crowd is like, okay, this song is fire. Oh shit, it's actually this person.
Right.
And yeah. now I can hang out and party with right. this person.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. But yeah.
So what's the date? What's
yeah, the so time? The,
what's all the... All the deets?
Yeah, so the awards are going to be happening on November 30th at the Abbey.
Cool.
The event will start at 7. I would say be on time because once we start doing certain things, the door will close until we open it again.
Fancy.
It's just going to be like timing of the door opening and right. timing of it closed just so that we're not interrupting what's happening. Yeah, it's been
there's level of fanciness that comes with that. I like that.
Yeah, because
I've never heard of that done, but I like that.
Hold people accountable for
yeah
them
yeah.
trying to be
late.
Yeah,
because people don't respect things unless you force them to. You yeah, know, yeah. like they. I mean, you can't get a refund. You're just gonna be standing outside watching it from the outside until we let you in.
Rain.
Yeah. You know,
rain.
Yeah, I'm really excited. We have amazing performances, and we're gonna be giving out 21 awards that night. What else? You guys are gonna be there?
Yeah, so right? I guess we can announce that. So, since it is on a Wednesday, we will be streaming the entire award show, yes. and me and Alex will be here. We will be interviewing people who win awards and who get off stage from their performance. We'll be reviewing their stuff too.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing we won't be doing, we won't be taking submissions that day.
Yeah.
But you guys will get to, we're going to have multiple cameras set up. So when the award show is happening, all the mics are going to flip over to the award show.
Right.
And you're going to actually watch the award show. We're going to flip to that camera. I mean, we may be picture in picture somewhere, but then it'll flip back to us. It'll kind of be like if you're watching a halftime show.
Yeah. Pretty much.
Oh, and thanks for the follow the ability. Thank you.
So yeah,
so they're gonna be live streaming the show, the entire thing, and I hope you guys watch it and have fun. I have so many amazing cool things planned. I don't know, I just wanted to do it differently. Like I wanted to do something that people don't get to experience before. Like one of the things I wanted to have is like that paparazzi outside type
Ooh,
feeling.
I love it. Yeah.
With the red carpet outside. So we're going to do all of that with like 15 camera crews outside with lights and just bright.
Cool.
It is a black tie attire event. You have to dress up. And we are located in Orlando, Florida. The event is going to be at the Abbey Orlando. At this time, there are no tables available, but you can go and get general admission. That's all we have left.
All right.
Cool.
And it's gonna be a good time.
Amazing.
If you can't make it or if you're working or something like that, you can tune into the stream.
Yep.
We will be here.
Yep.
We will be there. And I think the stream will start earlier that day. So
I think so.
Yeah, because the event starts at
7.
Yeah, so we'll be starting earlier. So just keep your notifications locked.
Don't miss the opening segment. Please don't. That's going to be fire.
Yeah.
We still running music? Yeah, tonight. Yeah,
we are.
I just went next door. So, but we are still doing music because we got DJ Mari sent this. This track is produced by him.
Okay.
But the artist is Mark Made. I met Mark Made. Mark Made's a really cool dude, man. So shouts out to him and shouts out to DJ Mari for sending that over. Mari has been, what's crazy is Mari's kind of is dope because been like he came up to me and I was like, yeah, man, I'll throw you some stuff. Like come out here, DJ with me, do this, do that, whatever. Mm-hmm. And he showed up and I told him, I'm like, hey, Tori might be looking for somebody. When you fully move to Orlando, here's a place where you can get your feet, like set your own thing up, do that.
Mm-hmm.
He's been doing his thing. And I had him at See You Monday on Halloween. And everybody's like, where did you find this kid? I'm like, I ain't find him.
He found me.
Yeah, he found me. Like, shit, he's fire. So it's dope seeing how his name is starting to bubble so quickly.
Good.
In Orlando as the DJ.
Cool.
So that's really dope. Mark want to pull up to the stream. Okay, true.
Oh.
All right. But this track is called XL. He said, what's good, family? This song is produced by me. It's out now on streaming platforms, a part of Mark Made's Monday 2 album. I appreciate any feedback. Peace and love. So let's listen right now.
My heart went out to play, but in the game I lost you. What a price to pay.
I like this.
Hey, Mari, you did your thing on this one, homie. Yeah, yeah.
Mari, you made it.
She a summertime sweet tea and no worth. Entree and appetizers, hors d'oeuvres. Independent out of school, so she done with class. Ain't gon' lie, I been studying the coursework. Oh, I pay attention to that presentation. In the market, the mass is looking inflated. Think I pre-qualify, submit the resume. Heard I run it like Rocky, but code is Appalachian. Celebrate over dinner, movies, and champagne. The climax had me double back for the matinee. So fly, would've swore she an angel. But she might be a devil with the mangoes. Oh, I got a good thing going, huh? Yeah, I got a good thing going, huh? Shorty bad, got a good thing going, huh? You can tell we got a good thing. And she don't need a man, he might hold her back. Everything about a fan, throw it in the bag. Keep it XL, never one for small chat. Make a mix sale, boy, you're lucky if she call back. She don't need a man, he might hold her back. Everything about a fan, throw it in the bag. Keep it XL, never one for small chat. Make a mix sale, boy, you're lucky if she call back. Can't touch her, she's smoking hot like a campfire. Amphibian, St. Tom, Coldest, New Hampshire. In a league of her own, sports in the top 10. Ooh, I'm on a highlight films, baby, Hall of Fame fitted. Authentic and independent. I still check up on her, refill that prescription. Can't tell if she naughty or nice. I just know when we argue, she right, and that's a damn shame. She's a wax cell, barely fitting in the frame. Friends looking flame, and they all quality of praise. Plus, I heard she got a thing for a nerd. So you know how she mean when I get on the nerves. Oh, I got a good thing going, huh? Yeah, I got a good thing going, huh? Shorty bad, got a good thing going, huh? You can tell we got a good thing. And she don't need a man, he might hold her back. Everything about a fan, throw it in the bag. Keep it XL, never one for small chat. Make a mix sale, boy, you're lucky if she call back. She don't need a man, he might hold her back. Everything about a fan, throw it in the bag. Keep it XL, never one for small chat. Make a mix sale, boy, you're lucky if she call back.
Hey, I got you.
Hold on 1 second.
Need a man, he might hold it back. Everything about a fab, throw it in the bag. Keep it XL, never one for small chat. Make a mix sale, boy, you're lucky if she call back. Can't. You did your thing on this one, homie. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, no. What's up, Hogan?
She a summertime sweet tea and no worth. Entree and appetizers, hors d'oeuvres.
You hear her.
All right, so I was just skimming through it to confirm, well, not confirm, just listen to different parts of the song and see. Trying to figure out if tonality changed, and I don't think it did.
Yeah. No.
I don't know. I think I got bored at some point.
Yeah. Okay.
Like it started off good. Mm-hmm. I was excited, and then I got bored. I was just like, I wanted to stay like that.
Okay.
That's my thoughts.
All right.
I feel like there was nothing, like, was there a chorus in there?
Yeah.
And if there was nothing differentiating it from the rest of the song. So,
and that's what I was checking for to see if, like, okay, did reverb get added? Did delay change?
There was like an effect that got added, but it wasn't enough to really scream, hey, we're doing a chorus.
The delay just got a tiny bit wetter.
Right. Yeah.
And so my advice would be moving forward. The vocals are clean. Like, his vocals are clean. And I mean, the other track, because I know I have this track, but I've listened to another one. The vocals are always clean.
Mm-hmm.
In this one, it started off where it felt like it slightly was sitting outside of the beat. And I think that's just because of two different places. Like, I don't know if he mixed into the stems.
Right.
I think he mixed over the beat.
Right.
So he just did the best that he could, even though, like, Mari probably has the stems and stuff. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with that. But he has a lot of high mids in his vocals, where I think he should leave a little bit more body in his vocals. So not cut out so much of the low and low mid side, like leave a little tiny bit in there. And then I think more more delay and reverb
just to open them up out of the middle
because it's not dry, and that's what I was checking for. It's not dry, but it sounds dry,
right?
Even the ad libs and stuff, it sounds like it is. Just there's a whole bunch of space around him that needs to be utilized.
Does anybody know if Hogan Moore has been in the...
Yeah.
I don't know if he's... is he here?
I don't think he's here.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that, and then...
what is happening?
And then, now let's get to the tonality. So, during the beginning of the song, it's like, all right, we're set. Then the chorus comes in, and it's like, okay, nothing... His tone didn't change.
Right.
The mix didn't get bigger. Not much changed.
Yeah.
And then it goes back into a verse, and then it goes back into a chorus. And then it just sounds like, all right, are we 5 minutes into the song? Are we 3 minutes into the song?
Well, it's because you're guessing. It's like, I've heard this part before. This must be the chorus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it needs to, and to do that, like make it bigger, I'll let Alex go there because that would be stereo widening and all of that stuff.
I mean, no, what you said is perfectly right. Like, going into a wider sound, you can add like ping pong delays, you could add like slap delays, you could add reverbs. There's little tricks that you can do where you take like the left side and pitch it down like 10 cents and the right side and pitch it up 10 cents. There's little things that you could do to just like
stack,
pop it.
Stack the chorus.
Yes, like literally just do layering like that. So just make it pop. Like, it's a very Taylor Swift thing to do, but it's pop. Like, when you hit a chorus, pop the vocals, make them wide. And it also screams, this is the chorus. Unless you're doing Look What You Made Me Do, and then you do the inverse of that. But that's what it is.
Yeah, I think, and I'm not sure about this, I'm about to check. I think he did the same cadence for the entire song.
That's what got me, I think.
And that can create monotony.
Is that Odd Ghosts? Is that what that is? Hey, you just submitted a song. Cool. Thanks for the submission. There's a chance we might not get to it, but we do this every Wednesday. As soon as it turns Wednesday, wherever you are, feel free to submit early in the morning or whatever, and you will be likely to get... We start at 8:30 every Wednesday. So,
yeah. Now, let me see.
Class. Ain't gonna lie, I've been studying the coursework. Oh, good thing going, huh? You can tell we got a good thing. And she just know when we argue, she right, and that's a damn shame. She's so Excel, barely fitting in the frame. Fab, throw it in the bag, keep it Excel, never want for small.
Okay, it kind of changes, but yeah, there just needs to be more...
just something that screams.
This is the chorus versus that's the verse.
Right, yeah.
All right.
And Hogan says, sounded like Got Me in My Feelings by Drake. I do hear a little essence of Drake in there. I wouldn't necessarily call it Drake, but I do hear an essence of it.
I was going to say Lloyd Banks.
Oh.
But it's not really Lloyd Banks, but I don't know why I hear Lloyd Banks, but it's not Lloyd Banks. But all right. Jen, did you say what you...
All right. Okay. All right.
So Jen is... Jen is in the middle of the gauntlet right now. It's in the middle of the gauntlet. She's been hanging out with us for a while now. All right. Up next, we got Weatherman Dan. He hit me up last
DJ
week.
DJ Mari with the 300 bits.
Oh,
thank you.
Well, shouts out to Mari. Last song was produced by DJ Mari.
Okay.
But the artist on it was Mark Made. Well, the rapper on it was Mark Made.
Yeah.
So definitely shouts out to them for sending that over. Mark Made sent in a track himself called Gushy, but in respects of the other people who have submitted, we're only going to do one Mark Made track tonight. So I guess whichever came first is the one.
Resubmit next time. Yeah.
Every week.
I Hope He Leaves song.
I don't know. That's by Sion. Yeah, we're gonna do that. But so up next we got
culture.
Yeah. Up next we got Weatherman Dan sent over a track called Blue featuring Nick Domenico. I think I got that right. Domenico. And then he says, Dear Alex and John, Thanksgiving is on the way, so I wanted to see how you feel about some footwork garage shit with a drill flair to it. We'll be out December with Category 5 with me and Mav. Dan.
What does that have to do with Thanksgiving?
It's Weatherman Dan, so nothing.
So, let's check this track out. It's called Blue.
All right, now.
Was that the music makes you lose control reversed in the beginning?
I get going with a drum and a juice.
Okay. Got the UKG.
Okay, let's go by, you could go both ways. I get hot, I could go towards space. Do your jet, do your dance. I'm so chill, I can hang with fans. Be on skill and you can't comprehend. Put the band down, cause you know I'm a stunt. Blood, finger in the air like a candle. What's up? Crush, dominant crust. It's jelly shit, cause I'm trying to be the one. Yeah, hey little nigga, don't touch my shoes. Don't talk rude when I'm in my mood. Get my lump sum, pay my dues. That's one way I don't feel so blue.
I like how it's building.
I get that. I might just roll one and get my lip back. Yeah, sit back. Okay, I get that. I might just roll one and get my lip. Stop banging the funk, go tell Daniel, just yes. Bang in the trunk. Okay, I'm changing it up, can't block that kick, no danger punch. Okay, cool. Y'all get loose like a motherfucker too. Okay, cool. I feel blue.
If anybody listened to Miami bass music, or if anybody was into having subs in their car and doing bass competitions, that 808 he's using is the standard subwoofer test 808. That doom. Like that is the standard test 808.
If we had it, it would just be shaking everything now.
It's bringing back so many memories. It's like there's Boom and Hydraulics uses that same 808. Uh-huh. Oh man.
But I feel like a troll.
I love this.
Yeah. I hate how it ends.
I do like it though. You should try to like get with the shuffling crews, like the girls that be shuffling.
Yeah.
And like, I feel like that would be like a great TikTok shuffling viral moment for you if you were to get like a couple dancers to do this. That's just my marketing point of view.
Okay, it's really wild next door now. But
yeah, what did you do, John?
Yeah, they turned it up. We got some dancers here in Orlando that we're working with, so maybe I'll put that in their pot for songs to dance to, because that's fun.
I mean, I feel like it's Weatherman Dan. I feel like that's,
well, he is a dancer.
Circles, yeah. Yeah.
He did ballet and stuff for years, so
I feel like he could find some people to really put something to it.
I can literally see people doing this on TikTok.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really really love that 808. It was nostalgic. That 808 was so nostalgic.
John's in another world.
Like,
right?
No, like the song's called Boom. I haven't listened to it in years, but right when I heard that 808, I was like, this is Boom and Hydraulics. Like, and this song was like a bass test. Like,
I took a really
cute Google Pixel photo.
The Google Pixel song.
Yeah.
You could submit, but I would wait until our next stream. As soon as it turns Wednesday, wherever you are, submit to www.consultqna.com. You'll find the submission button there. Probably we won't get to you tonight. We're starting to run kind of late. But yeah, the sooner you submit on Wednesday, as soon as it turns 8:30 Eastern Standard, and we start our stream, the sooner you'll be on that list. So
yeah. So listen to how this comes in. Our headphones might not even be able to produce it.
Too low. Oh yes, I remember this song.
But that 808.
My friend just had made his car at all like low end, and suddenly,
yeah. But like, it's the same 808.
It just extends. Yeah.
But yeah, I used to, because I had a 15 and a two-door hatchback. So
that makes perfect sense.
Yeah, good times. Good times. I downloaded that song, so cool. I'm holding on to it.
All right.
So shouts out to Weatherman
Dan. I do enjoy
Dan.
Some Weatherman Dan.
I need to turn it down. Turn it down next door.
What do we got? What do we got?
Up next, we'd have Gabe.
Gabe, where are
Ottaminelli.
Did
I say that right?
Ottaminelli, yep.
Ottaminelli. All right. Gabriel Ottaminelli. Track's called Who's Making All That Noise? All right. He said,
Next Door.
Next Door.
He said, this is a band called The Speed Spirits that I've been working with this fall. This is the last song on their upcoming 4-song EP. They have given me permission to submit music to you guys. Okay.
4 songs is an odd number, Gabe.
What about 6? What happened to 6?
4 songs is the exact number that he needs to turn in for my class because he's a student of mine this semester and that's his project is to do 4 songs. So is there a coincidence here? Kind of sus.
Yeah. Right. Oh, you teach at Valencia?
Yeah.
Oh, yep. Cool. I go there.
4?
Political science.
Oh, that's cool.
Unfortunately.
Hold on now.
I asked you. I was like, why would you do that? Why? Why?
What if I want to be like a mayor or something?
No, go ahead. Do it.
Do it.
Jen for mayor.
Yeah, do it.
Do it.
Definitely.
2050.
Just the stress. The stress, child. Politics. Oh.
I'm just kidding.
Yeah. No, that's, you know how politics are.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So this track is called Who's Making All That Noise?
Next Door.
Let's listen.
This friggin' song that comes on every week with all that key change.
All of these songs.
No change. God damn.
This is all in my right. Okay. It's like very low. Okay. Needs mastering.
Yeah. Give it a little bit more.
This is a really good mix.
It's the mastering that's.
It needs. It has, I don't think it has it been because it doesn't sound like it.
But that, like that tom right there, I'm concerned that this comes. The quietness comes from over compression on the output.
Okay. Because to me, it just sounds like it's been mixed and needs to be sent over because.
Right.
It sounds like everything for me, everything was just sitting well because right now it sounds like I'm listening to an old recording of people on Woodstock.
Right. Yeah, it's got that like 70s vibe to it, like early 70s. Yeah.
And that's really cool. I just feel like the mastering would make the vocals be more forefront,
right.
But also the instruments would be wider. Like it sounds very narrow.
Yeah. Yeah. You know? And that's. That to me is like it's very quiet because that's the level that the mastering guy wants to come in at.
This is what at negative what 14, 15?
I mean a mastering guy should be able to handle a minus 2 like easily. So I my only concern is that if there's an output like a master stage bus compressor that's like just pumping too hard. If you do have something on your master, it might be pumping too hard. But what Q said, I 100% agree. I think a really good master will bring this, like pull this out of its shell. All the components are there. It just needs to be cleaned up.
Oh man. Jen, how do you feel?
I like it. I'm getting too tired.
That's fair.
You're running the gauntlet.
Yep.
Like, I don't know how you guys do this. Like, y'all gotta pay these guys.
Thank you. Someone,
drop the cash apps. Send these men some monies. Because as somebody that literally makes a living from music, I can never do this for this amount of hours. Amp. I would literally lose my shit.
Thank you.
Amp, clip that.
Yeah.
Turn it into soundbite.
That's a real right there.
Yeah.
No, but for real. Like, I listen to music, but I don't listen to it for this extent amount of time.
That's why on certain, when people send me music any other day, I'm like, I'm not listening. I'm like, send it Wednesday because I'm not going to listen to it. Because I don't, like, I listen to what I want to listen to the whole week.
Same.
And I just say, and I save Wednesday for people who are like, can you check out my song?
But I think the difference is, though, like, you guys are really analyzing every part of songs and, like, really diving deep. And A&Rs don't do that this.
Yeah, most don't.
It's that inherent, like, gut feeling that you grow and you learn how to build, that you can just listen to something in 30 seconds and be like, nope.
Yeah, because an A&R, they're looking to see if this is going to be a hit or not.
Right.
That's really what they listen for. They don't really care about the other shit. Yeah. They think that they're going to hire someone to make it sound like it needs to sound if it's a hit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you guys are like, well, it's cool, but this shit needs to go high here, and this shit needs to go low here. And I'm like, wow, I would have just been like, I don't like the way you said this and that, and it didn't flow to my body.
Yep.
Fair.
But now, I'm happy to know that this is something that you guys do, because I didn't think it was like this.
Oh, yeah, super.
In debt.
Yeah.
I was mixing on the SSL using the bus compressor on the console. It could be that. It could be the bus compressor. You might not even need that output compressor. Just let the mastering engineer handle it.
All right. So up next. So shouts out to Gabriel Ottomanelli. Damn, I got it right. Look at that. He sent over that track, Who's Making All the Noise. I really like that. I like that band, too. Like, I want to hear more from that band.
Are
they in Orlando?
I think so. Or Melbourne. He's from Melbourne. Okay. So could be that.
Well, that's cool. I know I could probably send that band to Kate when they need openers.
Yeah.
And maybe they could open for some people at the social.
Valid.
Yeah. But so up next, we got Hogan Moore. He said, Brody and Hogan tape on the way real soon. Get on the feature, John. I told him, I don't know if I'm coming out of retirement, but
Nate, you'll be up after this.
Let's check this song out by Hogan and Brody's in. It's called Wawa. Let's see if it makes me want to come out of retirement.
That's the sound that chopper make when it go wah-wah, yeah. And I'm serving all the guests like I'm a wah-wah. Baddest bitch, she dancing on me, give me wah-talk. What's up in my cup, that shit, it be some wah-talk. Diamond dancing non-stop, I pull up in a drop-talk. And be crying like wah-wah, chopper hit the wah-talk, yeah, wah. Yeah, I feel like my jack, I'm
walking
on my fingers, these some bitch don't trigger it, shit, let that bitch blow. I just fuck.
The beat is fire, did Brody Zen make this?
Let that bitch go, I'm the man, I let that bitch know. Got that beat that make that bitch go. Bitch, I say go. Hold up, damn. How the fuck you fucking up the plan? But yo, I just made me am. This shit just made me who I am. Yeah, only did a pull up, hit that gym. Yeah, yo, bitch, pull up, then we caught her ass.
Yo, Kim.
Bitch, we hitting shots, I'm aiming way up for the rim. I'm paying for enhancements so that bitch could look like him. The way I do this shit, enhancing all this bitch, and they don't fit.
Thanks,
I bought a crib up in the Hanson just to say that I was there. That's the sound that chopper make when it go wah wah. Yeah, and I'm serving all the guests like I'm a wah wah. Baddest bitch, she dancing on me, give me wah talk. What's up in my cup? That shit, it be some wah talk. Diamond dancing nonstop, I pull up in a drop talk. And be crying like wah wah. Chopper hit the wah talk. Yeah, wah. Yeah, fuck all that wah wah shit.
All right, we got Maceo in the building. Shout out to him. Yeah, he popped by. We ain't got no room for him to hang out. So. But yeah.
Bitch, show me who you is. Tell me how you spend a meal. Yeah. I can't sip it unless I can crack the seal myself. Yeah. Chop a blissin' on the water like the Navy SEAL. Yeah.
Diamonds review this song.
On my neck, you know the carrots.
Review this song. Yeah.
Walk.
Oh, yeah. Pause it.
I feel like my jack, I'm gonna walk that bitch down. On my fingers, these some bitch don't trigger. It should let that bitch blow. I just fucked her, let that bitch go. I'm the man, I let that bitch know. Stop that beat that make that bitch go. Bitch, I said go. Hold up, damn. How the fuck you fucking up the plan? But yo, I just made me M. This shit just made me who I am. Yeah. When they did a pull up, hit the gym. Yeah. Yo, bitch, pull up, then we caught her ass on some film. Yeah. Bitch, we hitting shots, I'm aiming way up for the rim. Yeah. I'm paying for enhancements so that bitch could look like him. The way I do this shit, enhancing all the vision, they don't fit. I bought a crib up in the Hanson just to say that I was there. Yeah. Why? Yeah. Why? Why? Yeah. Why? Yeah. Wow, yeah. That's the sound that chopper make when it go wah wah. Yeah. And I'm serving all the guests like I'm a wah wah. Baddest bitch, yeah. Dancing on me, give me wah talk.
There we go.
Yeah.
Say that again.
That choir chant sample, yeah, thing that they got going on is nice.
I really like this from Hogan.
I was gonna say this is really good. This is Hogan?
Yeah, this is Hogan.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
I don't know who that is, but you guys sound
he's
impressed.
He's the dude. He's the brother.
Yeah, it's good.
The screen is shaking.
This is Kim's effect.
Oh.
Every time I talk, it moves now.
I'm cute.
I want to see you put all those clean effects, like all that vocal chain, and I want to see you like put a little bit more effort into this. I feel like you're kind of sitting on top of like the beat, which is an awesome beat, and like you're doing some really cool stuff. But I just want to, like, I've heard you be way better, and I want to see you take all those settings and apply them to this song and just kind of get your vocals in the mix and get them nice and clean.
Yeah, I think that's the only thing. It's kind of hard to hear him.
Yeah.
It's almost there.
It's almost
like
there.
It's almost,
yeah, there. He's just like ever so slightly like
and everything
muddy.
Else sounds good.
Yeah.
The beat sounds great.
Right?
The beat sounds really well organized and put together. I like that those choir chants aren't in it.
Yeah.
Consistently just kind of pops in mid-verse.
I think like for me, the thing that I like is that it's very nowadays industry sound.
Yeah.
Rather than like, sometimes, you know, there's not a lot of artists that can make music for now, what's currently happening, what's currently going, what you hear all the time.
Yeah.
I think it's very relatable. I like it.
That's awesome.
On hood.
Yeah.
How do you feel? I'm going to go.
I wasn't really listening. I was back here serving drinks. I knew it was going to happen. It was going to happen.
Luckily, it missed the console.
Thank God it should happen. Oh, well.
You got napkins back? Bartender?
Actually, I don't think I do. But I can go find a towel back here. If you guys will hold down the show for me.
It's all good.
You got to hold down the show now. I got to find some towels.
My apologies. I was trying to include John by reaching back.
Reaching back when all of these cables are this long. So as soon as you turn, it goes boink.
I wanted to give him the headphones, and I was like, oh, wait. And as soon as I saw that, they
it's all good. It's all good.
But did anyone else have any good songs by the time I hopped out the stream?
We've done like two, because that's how
the
we
guy
do
that
things.
Had the band was good.
Oh yeah, Gabe did his. Okay. We had some indie rock happen.
Okay.
Yeah.
There was something else.
Good. We're going very long today.
I was gonna say it's been going on for a while, but you guys went on long last week too, though.
Yeah, I think it's crazy to think about.
Yeah.
There was a hurricane a week ago.
This is the fact.
Yeah. Like, I was driving home, like...
Oh, yeah. Weren't you driving home?
I was driving home, like, later after this, and it was like... And I was like, huh, it's kind of blowy out. Like, this might be dangerous.
Hey, that's different, though.
Yeah.
Someone got to do it. Someone's got to do it. How many people are left in the queue?
There's a couple. If you go to the tab right there, click on that. And that's the queue. Everything that's in blue is people that are here.
Sion left.
He might still be here.
Yo, Sion, you still in the chat?
Oh, there we go.
Hey,
I think
Sion,
Nate is
are
next.
You still here?
And I think that we're going to do Sion for the culture.
You got to do Sion for the culture, though.
Yeah.
Sion, I'm going to say this right now. Sion is like the dopest vocalist in the city, point blank period. I don't think that there's another vocalist, male or female, that's really going. No, I'll stand on that. Yeah. I don't think there's another vocalist, male or female, that's going against him, myself included. I went to high school with him.
Oh, yeah.
Known him for a long time. He works his ass off. His songs are really well fucking put together. He's an amazing writer. Like, his lyrics are really good.
Yeah.
He has a song called Lazy Sunday that is so well written, in my opinion. And as a person who values my words,
yeah,
and my lyricism, he's really great at it. And yeah, I've watched him do his thing for a long time. And I'm proud of him.
You good?
I'm sorry, John.
This man over here laughing.
I'll buy you some food after. I promise. You want tacos?
Nate, I think you are. He's next. Upset. We'll do our changeover here. Thanks for popping by. You just decided to come out tonight?
Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah. You know who's DJ next door?
What is his name? Who's DJ next door?
Is Jax next door?
Yeah.
All right, guys. It's Jennifer H. Desire. We're about to move on to the next artist. Yeah, so I'll be hosting my events, and I'll be moving through that shit fast. Like, I mean, all right, next artist coming up is such and such. Let's go.
We have a running joke. Yeah.
Bye. I know, right?
We have a running joke that if we get through 10, we're doing good.
Shit, we not even at 7. We're doing horrible.
Yeah, we're more laid
Which
back.
Which one is it?
It's whatever. Oh, hey
there goes John. Applause.
Whoever was just here cleaning the floor was just very rude.
Oh,
yeah.
Was it?
Yeah. Hmm.
They didn't go
just making
job.
Faces.
I heard spilling drinks was rude.
When I moved it. Because I was like,
wasn't even over here. It was right there where you moved it to.
I don't want
to
hear it.
He's mad at me.
Well, my mom texted me, said she's listening.
So now we have to play.
Sion? Yeah.
So, but I do want to get to Nate. Did we skip Nate?
Nah, no, Nate. It'll be Luz, then Nate.
Okay.
And then Madeira. Is Madeira still around?
Yeah. I think I've seen that name. So are we doing Sion next? Or are we doing something else?
I mean, I think people have pulled the card, so he has to be played.
Yeah.
Oh, he said his name's not Celine Dion.
Well, now it definitely is.
I made it a note to call him by his real name, but now he might be Celine Dion.
Forever.
Or Sion Dion. There we go. He's Sion Dion now.
Sion Dion.
So where it's like half correct and then it still has
enough to really make
what?
The point.
Is it you, Celine Dion? Is that what you mean? No, Sion Dion.
No, Sion Dion.
All right.
Did you hear what I say? I said Sion Dion.
He sent over this track called I Hope He Leaves.
Oh.
Let's check this out.
Okay.
Hopefully the person leaves. Okay.
Are we?
I wonder who.
Me too. Jen, what you know?
I don't know shit.
Ooh. 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 Ooh.
Everything.
you. Oh, baby, how did he please you?
Amp, I have never met him.
Yeah. Like, how you used to be my cinnamon apple. You meant the world to me. I always put you right in the front for the whole world to see. But all that shit was never enough. So now you moved on to someone that's gonna treat you wrong. And when you try to come back home, it's fuck you, you're meaningless. Yes, bitch, I mean it. Anything and all the things you said to me, no mean shit. Don't try to twist this on your position. You fucked up everything. You heard me remember the day when I loved you, babe. I loved you through anything. Now I want you gone. Remember the day when you're hurting, baby, baby girl. I hope he needs you. I hope you'll see how we feel when you walk down the beach. Cry me a river. Cry me back to me. Cry me. I'll use your tears to wash my feet.
My review is it's perfect.
I have thoughts on production, but that's it.
Okay.
I have no thoughts.
Oh my God, what is this note?
The writing is great. The vocals are great. No.
You should play him one of these days.
One of these days, I would have to have his music.
Just go on Spotify.
I don't. Spotify.
Is it working?
Help.
Yeah.
We bike.
Okay. I don't have Spotify.
Spotify.
It's unfortunate.
Nah, but I don't think Flozig and Sion are comparable as artists.
Okay. No, I just thought you were telling me it was Sion, but I remember you telling me about Sion before.
Probably.
Yeah.
Sion is good. He's really good.
He's amazing.
I don't really have any thoughts.
It's a good song.
I think
that this song could benefit from a really good round of mastering. I think that there's some overall frequencies that aren't quite right. And I feel like his vocals could sparkle and be more airy just at a little bit more, but not from a mix standpoint. It just needs to be an overall cleanup kind of sound. I think if this song had a very involved master, it would just blow the doors off of what it is now, because it would take everything that's like, to me, like 90% and just take that 10% and just make it so anything that you played it on, it was like, it just screams amazing. Okay. It's a great song, but it needs just that final polish to make it great and universal on what it plays on. Somebody's on our other account watching too, so
that's cool. Yeah. I mean, the bot's telling him.
Yeah.
So, all right. So, shouts out to Sion for that. I'm pretty sure my mom liked that. So, that's what's up. All right, and since Amp pulled this card, did Luz ever pop in and say
I didn't see him.
Okay, but Amp pulled the card. He said he wants to hear Luz. So, okay. He said this is so far from finished. My bad if it's ass. All right,
this is what he wants.
Let's check it out. It's called Hotel Room.
Okay.
If you know it's ass, then it's probably ass.
Hey. Did the music get louder?
Yeah. Cause in this crowded room, you still know that's me. And girl, I love the way your eyes tell me to take a lead. Go far, throw me into the dark. Cause it's so hard to live this life. Cause I'm shackled to the darkness in my mind. And I've been trying to be behind all the memories of a past life. Cause girl, I see you dancing in another man's hotel room. Girl, I should've known by the way he looks at you.
working on that 80s album together.
Who?
Blues and Viuda. I hope they are.
That would be amazing.
They both have this. I mean, they worked together before, but it's like both the stuff that they're making independently has the same sound.
Yeah.
Or a very similar sound that if it was a duo,
it would make more sense.
It would just explode. Like if they did joint projects and joint songs all the time, it would be fun. Even if they were a duo, like granted, still do the solo, but actually work as a duo.
Yeah.
Somebody said it reminds them of The Weeknd.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. This is Weeknd Part 2.
Yeah.
Yep. That's all I thought of when I heard it.
But that's not a bad thing because nobody else is really in The Weeknd's lane.
And that's also true.
And he sounds like an older version of The Weeknd. Mm. Like the older Weeknd, which Weeknd doesn't sound like too much.
Right.
Do you like The Weeknd?
I don't listen to The Weeknd.
Do you like Drake more than you like The Weeknd?
I only listen to Drake flips.
Okay.
So when Drake stuff comes out, I'm like, I can't wait for SoundCloud to remix it.
Yeah.
And then I'll listen.
So you can see what happens.
I'll listen to the remixes and then go listen to the Drake song and be like, the remix is so much better.
This probably doesn't have anything to do with this, but Kim's been sitting there snacking the entire time.
Oh, yeah. That's what she does. Just eat snacks the whole stream.
Also, too, we're still on the shake setting and that's never going to go away.
Are we?
Yeah.
For the music?
For the music.
Oh. All right. But, yeah, I don't know what he wants us to talk about when it comes to that. Because, I mean, his vocals were dipping behind the beat at times. Mm-hmm. But I don't know what's not done about it.
Yeah.
Except for, like, the vocals dipping behind the beat a little bit. I mean, it's 1 minute long.
Yeah,
so.
I have nothing. I've got nothing.
I mean, I don't think it needs to be a 2 minute and 45 second song. It could be 2 minutes. You could just
hit it with another strong chorus and call it a day.
Yep.
Do we have
Is Nate the Great up next?
Yeah.
And then
it's that time.
Is Madeira still here or nah? So I'm gonna hit done on this.
Otherwise, we're out after that.
Yeah, because it's 11:30. We've been doing this for a long time right now. And Jen has completely checked out.
Yeah, I'm sleeping already.
Yeah, she's asleep.
No, like, it's past me. I gotta be up early.
Yo. That's why we're gonna try to. Madeira hasn't said anything.
So
we're gonna end it with Nate the Great then.
All right.
Nate the Great says, hope y'all enjoy my first stream. Dope little setup you got. I'm rocking with it. Well, Nate, welcome to your first stream. If you don't know, which you probably don't because this is your first stream, we set up all over the place every other week. All the time. So the setups change. If you go look back at the old streams on YouTube, you'll see the main house for this setup is my house. So right now we are in a bar downtown Orlando. But let's check this track out. It's called The Conscientious Objector. Oh,
I already feel like him and Overdue Revolution would be friends.
Let's see what this sounds like.
All right.
This sounds like
take me to another world.
Whoa.
That's what you think. I think it's some conscious shit.
I think it's my hippopotamus and hippocampus and hippocampus.
Shit don't make no sense.
I feel like,
are we taking bets on this?
I feel like
underovers.
Okay. My bet is I feel it's going to be big words galore.
Big word hippopotamus.
Yeah, hippopotamus.
And how the universe is, I don't know.
And then my third eye can see
exactly
in
the element within and all of that stuff.
I think it's
the element within.
This is now that's tacky. I think it's some metal core.
Okay.
I think it's just straight. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, he said I was right though.
No.
Which part?
Okay. No, we gotta
listen.
No,
we'll
no,
find
we
out.
Listen
we'll
to
find out.
We gotta listen. We're taking bets. We gotta listen to it. All right.
Well, I was wrong.
No, you were
very wrong.
Alex is eliminated. But it could do.
No, it's about to talk about the third eye.
In case you thought that you were special, look. My foot and blueprint on a huge level. You big man, cause I'm doing shit that you can never. Commandment number 9. I don't have to lie. You've been fed up all because I do it better. Until I put two and two together, super clever, selling you perspective to a
y'all.
And then do it never. Me, I'm doing good. And I could be doing better. Cause I get in my head sometimes. Everyone I know is so far away. Even though they just call the way. There isn't much to the pros that I gotta say.
She probably pick up the phone once I finish the song. Cause I've been grinding so hard, I've been needing it to y'all. And I can't help but feeling like this is my fault. It's been a minute and a minute is a minute too long. I like to keep the friends close and the enemies in submission. Ironically, that's the easy part. Look at my competition. They portray a fraudulent image. I don't even got a diss. Cause what is self-deprecation to a limited edition? I'm an asshole for a snowflake. Naturally on the cocaine. You want the truth of the whole thing. Can't handle it, then go away. Wait, where do I reside? Where truth is found?
Can we turn the screen shake off? That is like epileptic shock right there.
I was wrong.
The week before I spoke and break it down.
Kim can hear you.
Turn off the screen shake, please.
It's trippy.
Turn off the screen shake. Yeah. Yeah.
Cause looks like you were saying got a new sprain and it wasn't due to a shoelace. But it only hurt for a few days. Ain't temporary as a moon phase. Everything that you
think. You were more right than metal scream.
That's true.
I think honestly his singing voice could be emo. You could use your singing voice. Like right here, I was like, okay, he sounds like
whatever, just don't say you'll do it and then do it now.
I feel like this is very similar in delivery to 21 Pilots.
Okay.
You guys heard that song, It's a Vibe.
Yeah.
By Blueface's girlfriend with the tattoo.
With the tattoos.
I don't know her name.
But it kind of reminded me of that. I don't know why. Okay. It just reminded me
of
that.
It's got like a little bit of like happy like tonality to it. Yeah.
But I was very wrong.
Yeah.
This is a very interesting song, actually. Yeah. There's a lot of delivery styles.
The name is different.
Yeah. And I didn't actually mind some of the rhyming. Mm-hmm. It wasn't obnoxiously like A-B-A-B-A-B.
Yeah.
It was very storytelling A-B-A-B-A-B, which I think is different.
Hmm.
I dig it, actually. I'm okay with it.
Whatever, just don't say you'll do it.
Go ahead.
I was going to say the name. It's going to be very... people are going to expect certain things. And that's not what they're going to get.
Yeah.
I don't know. That may be a good thing or a bad thing. It just depends on how you look at it.
It's a big word name where people have predetermined notions about it.
Yeah.
Just like how we were like, oh my God, is this going to be hippopotamus, hippocrolic?
Yeah. And that would be the deciding factor of whether or not you listen to that song. Mm-hmm. May or may not be. I don't know. Yeah, I wouldn't.
That's true. Yeah, that's true.
But I tell you what, though,
it does make me curious about what else you got.
Yeah.
So, you know, feel free to submit more because I'm interested in hearing other stuff that you got.
Do you have some screaming shit or do you have
some? Yeah, please say you got some like
in my room. That's exactly what I feel like he could do.
Thoughts in my head. I can't stop having
my hospital bed.
In my hospital bed. Feelings I can't describe. Conscientious weather. Let's fuck my goddamn.
Yo.
Yeah.
You guys are crazy.
Yeah, that would be. I don't know why nobody wants to. Like. He could have it.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you could definitely do that. This is what I hear now.
Like some like.
And my thoughts and I never say. Finally stop my wandering.
Yeah, like what's that band? Like Attila, the delivered that. Like that very aggressive. Drop it, man. I'm here for it.
He would need
to. Do you listen to a lot of emo songs?
Emo night is Thursday, of course. Yeah.
Wow.
Have you ever been there. To emo night? No, it's at Beecherman Social.
You go there?
It's tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Yeah.
Is fire.
But it's also over there. It's based out of there, and then it drifts over here.
Okay. Well.
So, like, you go there to go there, or you
no,
go there
I just
pop
in. Okay. I pop in. I'm DJing next door, so.
Okay.
Yeah, I just pop in and hear Every time I walk in, it seems like they're playing Bullet for My Valentine.
My tears don't fall. They crash around me.
Oh my goodness.
or like Bring Me the Horizon. Yeah, Sum 41 or Bring Me the Horizon.
I don't think I listen to any emo songs.
Well,
Jen, and technically none of this is emo either. Emo is Jimmy Eat World.
But they play all of that. So mm-hmm. It's pretty much they should just change it to early 2000s.
That's
In 90s and early 2000s is what it should be called.
There used to be a label in town called 111, and it was owned by one of the boy band boys, and it was where I got started in production. And there was the first band I ever did was like borderline Jimmy Eat World emo, so ready to pop, but then they didn't. Very sad story. Very sad.
There is a lot of emo people that comes to those events.
Oh yeah.
They be dressed up. I like seeing that shit.
Well, they play I Make Sins Not Tragedies or whatever.
Panic
at the Disco.
Yep.
And yeah, you know, they do a heavy emo, but then they will go into like Yellow Card.
Yeah,
because
it's like reminiscent of 2000s when emo was in its prime.
Yeah.
But also Yellow Card is happening, so we're gonna listen to that.
It's
also
like, all right, you know, they won't go System of a Down though.
No,
they'll do like they but won't go that.
I still firmly feel that that's coming back. We're just not there yet.
Oh, I wish new metal would.
Yeah,
I wish it would.
I feel like Deftones is like right coming.
Yeah,
it's starting to peek its face out a little bit more.
Jen's just like, yeah, I don't know any of these.
I don't listen to none of this shit. Nah,
it's amazing.
Like, let me tell you guys something. I am Haitian, okay? To my family, this shit is bad, okay? It is devil music.
I never understood that. Because, I mean, that's what they would always say. And I'm like, because they're, like, doing devil voices.
Right.
I'm like, what is a devil voice? What is a devil voice? How would anybody know what a devil sounds like other than movies?
Honestly, I really don't understand why my family thinks that. But I think, like, growing up, just being around that environment where they thought like all that stuff was bad, it just kind of like it stuck with me. So
a lot of it is very political and about how the system is bad. Not emo. Emo is more like I'm hurting.
Emo's hospital bed.
But like the stuff that does a lot of like that's very usually political or about like how something's fucked up and
or about a girl.
Yeah.
Yeah. My mom used to think that wearing like those bracelets on your foot, like your anklet, the anklets was like a devil thing.
Oh,
like
wow,
exactly. Okay. So it's like a lot. Like I think, like when you think about like third world countries and like stuff that we go through, like a lot of stuff comes down to like the deviling
perception
stuff
of
and
it.
The perception
yeah.
of it. So I think that's my take
we
on
go
it.
Go down a rabbit hole of why,
I know,
but... Nate. you've only listened to rap. There's a 2003 album by a band called Brand New called Deja Intendu that you should listen to.
Well,
it's a good source of emo that will inspire you to write well.
I don't think Nate sounds like emo. I just think he could do it.
He's got the potential to lead into that.
You could do it, or you could do like the Yellow Card is. What was Yellow Card considered?
Just pop rock.
Yeah, rock.
I've seen that band like 8 goddamn times too. My wife is my favorite, her band.
Yeah,
so whenever they were a band, to the point that she would get all of the VIP,
what?
To the point that she knew them. So like on their last show in Orlando ever, the violin player was just standing outside waiting for his family. And she's like, Hey, it's you. Come meet my husband. And I just met all of them.
Oh, wow.
Just cause she knew them. Just cause she... had been to so many shows. It's bonkers.
That's me.
Well,
yeah.
Yeah, so that's what we're saying.
That Wednesday
to that. But about your song. Yeah, that's true.
Fraudulent image where truth is found.
Again,
it's a fun song.
Yeah, it's okay. I would want to hear something else though. Like this is okay.
Yeah. Okay.
He said it's not emo.
It is very to me it's in the lane of Logic. So and that's okay. I've done a show with Logic before. It was when he was stopping smoking, so he didn't want anybody to smoke around him. So that was like a ban in the venue. Like none of the staff could smoke. Yeah. They had to like leave property to smoke. Yeah, shouts out to Logic.
Fair.
I wasn't mad at it. I don't smoke, so but yeah. It was like, it's an extreme request just because you're...
Just because of you?
Yeah, just because, like, you don't want anybody in your sight smoking a cigarette. So, I guess, I don't know. To me, it felt a little prima donna, people, but, yeah. You know.
What you allow is what
people say Russ and Logic for that song. Yeah, I get a lot of Logic for it. I want to hear something different. It's not bad or anything like that. I get it. It's not something I would listen to, but I don't listen to Logic or Russ. So, okay.
That's Wednesday.
Yeah, that's what we're going to get up out of here.
Thanks,
so.
Everybody, for hanging out.
Yeah. Shouts out to everybody. Shouts out to Jim for being a trooper.
For dealing with us.
Being a trooper. You have made it through the
Congratulations.
Gauntlet. A lot of people don't make it this long.
This is true.
You're one of the outside, like, I mean, yeah, you're in the music industry. I think all the music industry people make, well, Tiffy made it this long. Yeah, not many people make it this long. They always like, yo, it's 10 o'clock, man.
My head is popping.
But shouts out to everybody who is joining us and hung
Are
out with
done?
Us. Yes, yeah, it's that
oh,
time.
God, yeah. Thank you.
Not next week, but the week after, we'll be at the Fusion Awards.
Yeah, it'll be. Yeah, because I shouldn't be working that night. No,
Wednesday?
I shouldn't be. Not yeah, it's the last. Week. It's the last Wednesday in a month, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's five Wednesdays this month, right?
You're good.
I don't know.
Yeah. It literally falls on the last day of the month.
Yeah.
You're good.
So yeah, I'm not here.
Cool.
So
oh,
yeah.
There?
Yeah, I gotta do all this.
Oh, that's why Consistency said he's gonna be there, because he said I don't work that day.
Ah, perfect.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Yep.
Good timing.
Yep.
Fell yeah, on that. Last Wednesday of the month.
All right. But next week we will be at my crib. You know, we're gonna be back on the couch.
I won't be there.
Yep.
You just have to deal with this yourself.
You can hang out in the background if you wanted to.
I might learn something.
You could be like Amp. In the background. The stare bat. The stare goblin.
Nah. The stare goblin.
That's what he does.
What? Who was
no, that? That was what's his name? He was just sitting on the stairs the whole stream, and everybody was like, who is that?
Who is they? Never introduced himself, just went and stood in the shadowy
Amp
background.
Said he might be there. I have to go to the gym tomorrow at 8 o'clock in the morning.
Well, not with you.
Wild.
Good luck.
All right.
I don't know why I did that. I signed up for something at 8 o'clock.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
On a Thursday?
Yeah. Huh. Well, guys.
All right.
Thank you so much. Tomorrow I am DJing inside the patio. That is from 10 to sometime. Other than that, it is emo night at the Social in the Beecham. So if y'all are into emo music, you can go to emo night. They are doing the live band.
It's going
to
be fun
slash
time.
DJ thing.
Yeah.
So that's going to be cool if you really like that music. I got to get a new tire tomorrow.
You driving around with that Bolt?
Yeah. I got to get a new tire tomorrow.
Yeah, actually, I have school all day tomorrow. Yeah.
10 to 6.
Good times.
I think I'm 2 to 8.
I think I'm going to do a mix tomorrow and put it out.
Do it.
If I have time.
Okay.
Do it.
Yeah, I haven't done. People are low key like, why are you not doing mixes? I'm like, oh, you noticed.
I was wondering.
Yeah, but. So.
All right.
But thank you guys for tuning in and allowing me to chime in.
Thanks for hanging out.
I'm Jen. You can follow me on social media platforms at Jennifer H. Desire.
There you go.
That is all.
Pay attention.
All right. We're going to do a song to get up out of here. For the thingy.
Okay.
So it's not that awkward.
It's not just us, just like, so now what?
So click. Uh-oh. Wait.
Pay me what?
Jules at it.
No, that's.
Oh, sweet. We got the hot.
Oh, hot photos. Oh, YouTube going crazy. I can do it here.
What is this?
Kim about to drop the band hammer. Oh.
Nah, I did it. Oops, something went wrong. Okay, I can't do it.
Man. All right.
Let's see. What we want to get out of here to... I got...
Goodbye.
You asked me about Drake. Why? Do you like Drake?
Do you like Drake?
Jennifer, do you like Drake?
If you like Drake.
No. Okay, so we're going to play... we're going to do this... Damn, which one do I want to do? I don't even
know.
Let's just do the thong song.
Sweet.
But I'm a piano.
I'm a piano.
Wow.
Song is sexy.
All right.